Hey, welcome fools, punks, fools, to the CNR radio interview session here. We're in Los Santos right now, even though we're going to change to LB in about 20 minutes, but we got to get something in before we change. In a few minutes, we're going to talk to Ham Chilla, part of the Oldie Ganag. Been here since a lot of you, since before a lot of you guys were born. Very bad to say, but we got a sponsor here. Gonna talk about the bidet. I'm not gonna give any explanation because the sponsor is pretty long. So let Joey Diaz take care of this. Here it be.
I'm gonna talk to you people about something. Father's Day's coming. You know, I was joking around and shit about your father's asshole before. I don't know if your father's asshole smells. I'm just using particulars. I'm 54, and from time to time to time, I scratch my anus in the middle of the day and I sniff it because I'm curious. And I know it's got some wang to it. And I immediately go to the fucking Hello Tushy. And I wash my ass off. And I even bust out soap sometimes and put the fucking towel in there and mix it all up and get the brown eye clean. And you're ready to go. You're confident about your asshole. You want your dad to be confident. HelloTushy.com. The bidet is back, okay? You don't know what a fucking bidet is? Let me tell you what a bidet is. A bidet is a device that washes your little muffler clean after you go to the bathroom right there. Now, to install one will be thousands of dollars. You don't need that. HelloTushy.com is a new portable bidet that you install. Right, it goes right into your toilet. Bada bada boom. So after you take a la staminkia, or after ladies, after you get a little stabbing, and he shoots that little fucking techno glue in your monkey. You know what I'm saying? No. You get that love plasma in that fucking skunk of yours. You went out three nights this week and got three different cocks. What do you think that hoe smells like? You think that's a pleasantry for anybody? Thank God this last guy had a bidet. You could just crack that cricket, put that water in it, throw some soap in that motherfucker, and ping, pang, boom, your monkey's back and shit. Anyway, whether it's a muffler, whether it's your monkey, whether it's your helmet, Hello Tushy does it all. You understand me? But they focus on the muffler. The muffler is the whole thing. Why? Because that's where diseases start. That's where you get hemorrhoids and you get different itches. And different diseases. You get fucking crab rat. What is that crab? What is that crab crotch? When people are sitting there and they're scratching their ass, whatever, crab scratch, whatever the fuck it's called, you get that from sitting in your office all day. Never again. It's a portable device. You go home, you sit on that thing, you don't have time for a shower. You fucking put the cold water right in your little muffler. Oh my God, you don't know what peace and serenity is till you have a little water hitting your little muffler in the afternoon after a long, stressful day at the office, God, or wherever you've been. Hello Tushy is guaranteed for 90-day guarantee. Nothing will happen. And they ship right to your house. Do me a favor. Go to HelloTushy.com. Look at the portable bidet. You're going to fall in love. You're going to fall in love, okay? You're not going to buy one of them. You're going to buy two of them. One for your dad and one for your mom, because their asshole's been looking like it got some wang to it from time to time. You know what I'm saying? She's eating those biscuits again and shit backs up in that little muffler. Anyway.
You can buy one for the office.
Buy for the office. Go to HelloTushy.com right now and press in.
/church.
What is it?
HelloTushy.com/church.
Boom! And get 10% off your new Hello Tushy. Never have a stinky asshole again.
All right. That was the bidet Hello Tushy. Obviously in this time of turmoil where it's one batch of toilet paper per person and people are buying it and going back in line, you gotta find other alternatives to wash your ass. And Joey Diaz showed it to you. Anyway, so we got our third interview of the month. Holy snit, never seen that before. I guess the corona gave it to us as well. But again, your host here, Rashawn and Cash, and this time we have Ham Chilla around here. What's up, Ham Chilla?
What's up, Rashawn? Good to be here today.
Yep, good to be here in the great month of April. Couple days after 420. Same month as my birthday, so GG for that. But how's the corona? Did I celebrate it? Did I celebrate 420? No, yeah. I did not.
Why not?
I am not. Listen, I'm all for the legalization of weed everywhere, but I don't actively try to go out and seek it. You know what I mean? It's one of those things where it doesn't bother me at all, but I'm not going to. It's not my thing, you know. You know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
Do you dabble in weed, Hamjula?
Not since I was in high school, but it is completely legal where I live right now, so it's kind of tempting.
Which state is that?
The great state of Massachusetts.
Oh, damn. Right above Connecticut in the Northeast. There's a lot of Corona going on right there as well. People must be coping with that by getting some weed, but has the Corona affected you in any way?
Oh, hell yeah. I've been stuck in the house so fucking long. Why do you think I'm here?
Are you one of those people who were protesting? Like, yesterday I saw in news some crazy American people protesting, this is the land of the free! We are all to go out, be free, do whatever we want.
No, I'm stuck in the house. I've hoarded food and toilet paper. I am not leaving till the shit's done.
But they say that the social distancing may have to continue until 2022. How are you going to cope with that?
What? 2 more years?
Let's go. I'm a hermit. I'm an introvert. I don't do shit. Let's go. I'm down.
Yeah, I feel you, bro. I'm telling you. This corona, you know, despite the fact of having to wear a mask to strengthen the lung muscle, besides that, okay, I just called the lung a muscle. I'm not really sure if that's true, but besides that, it hasn't really affected me all that much, you know? So, yeah. Get it. Plus, guess what? Traffic is a lot less, you know? And traffic in Connecticut, bro. There's only like 2 major highways around here. Fucking sucks. So, to see the highways all clear, I don't know if you have to drive or anything, but to see the highways all clear is a great thing for me, cocksucker.
I think I'm gonna have to drop a bombshell real quick. Start this interview off hot.
Oh, really?
I'm like 80% sure I might have had it like a month ago.
Corona? Really?
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
I'm pretty sure I had Corona when I was in USA.
I don't know, actually, I may have had it too. I mean, like, there was this day, I think it may come from hitting myself, though, because I hit myself in the chest with something, and then... That same night, right? It was like 2:50 a.m. Yeah, I was feeling good until then. Well, then it's the same day, so it probably isn't true. But I went to bed. I tried to go to sleep on my right side, but it felt like my lung was like, I don't know, collapsed or something, you know? And then I got up, I was trying to walk it off, and then I got the chills. And I'm like, bro, what the fuck's going on? I haven't had the chills since, like, 2009. So I had the chills for, like, 20 minutes, and I was like, man, how am I going to go to sleep? So I just went to sleep on my left side, and, you know, it was fine. But I was actually a little bit sick a couple of months ago. You know, the cough, the mucusy throats, and all that. I didn't have any fever or anything. I think I caught it from some dude who was coughing all the damn time, because some old man likes to fucking cough. I don't think it was the corona either, though. You know, I feel like if you are gonna have the corona, you probably would know in some way, but I don't know. I have no idea.
I didn't think I had it. I mean, I had a cough, I had congestion. I didn't have a fever, but the one thing that was really screwy, I've never had it before, but I couldn't taste anymore. And then weeks later, I found out that that is a symptom. And I was like, fuck.
Yeah. Well, in that case, might have had it.
But it's like, I don't know, I guess if you would actually have corona, you would have temperature, because that's kind of always there. Like, for everyone pretty much who has corona, has the temperature.
I don't know. I don't know.
Actually, I took my dad to the hospital yesterday, and it was like emergency sort of thing, and I had to take him to emergency ward, and they measured my temperature and everything, of course, before I could get in the hospital, and my dad as well and everything. And then the lady lets me know that I cannot leave hospital because there was a corona patient walking like 3 meters in front of me, and they have to disinfect everything, and they don't let anyone out until they have like completely cleaned. So the dude who has been walking in front of me has corona confirmed. So yesterday night I was like, oh, I hope I didn't touch anything. I hope I didn't, like, you know, I had a mask and stuff on, but I was like, yeah, I was a little bit worried. Because you always think, yeah, nothing's gonna happen, nothing's gonna happen. But that dude, like, had it confirmed. And the lady was like, since you're, like, you were, like, in 10-meter radius of him, like, you cannot go home until we check you and shit like that. So I was like, yikes.
Wait, Slovenia had an instant corona test at that time?
Well, I didn't get tested. They just told me, like, if I get temperature, because it won't show that quickly anyway. She was like, well, that dude in front of you, like, he has corona confirmed. And they took him, like, to a respirator. He was, like, on bed already. Like, they took my dad in on bed, on, like, hospital bed. And they took him as well on hospital bed. And I was just walking behind those beds, you know, just getting my dad in hospital. And then the lady was like, well, that dude in front of your dad who was on bed, he has corona. So, like, if you start feeling unwell in next, like, 10 days or something, you should come back immediately. I was like, okay. Yeah,
look at that. But, you know, another case, we have Chillum said he might have had the corona while it seems like he was already self-quarantining. Because, you know, losing your sense of taste is a very distinct symptom. So you probably got an immune punk over here. Look at that. That means you can go back into society, Angela. Not that.
I'm just that good.
You're just that good. I mean, that's how it is. Anyway, usually the first question is usually the same. So, how and when did you find CNR, Angela?
That's a weird question. I've been thinking about that for a while. I started 2008, 2009. And the how, I remember I was like a freshman in high school, or maybe in like eighth grade at that point. And I was looking at like San Andreas mods on YouTube of like, I remember seeing like Dragon Ball Z type bullshit.
There you go.
So I pirated the game, and then just to do the mods. And for some reason in the files was San Andreas multiplayer.
It was already there.
It was fate.
Damn, 2-for-1. Somebody hooked you up there, man.
So yeah, I hopped on, started playing, played like a couple of random servers, and then found CNR, and I haven't switched to another server since.
Didn't look back, huh? The people were just too good back then, huh?
Something like that. I mean, I tried a deathmatch server, and I suck at killing people, so that didn't work out.
Yeah, plus by 10 FPS.
And then the other things, like the RP servers, I went on like one, and like it was so dry and boring that I'm like, after 30 minutes, I was like, peace.
Yeah, what is it about RP servers that people actually like? That there was a trend like in 2011 where a couple of DMH dudes are trying to get on LSRP, and they were really into that crap. I don't understand what the appeal is to RP servers.
Too much work for a virtual life.
Exactly. At least, you know, with this server, it's not really RP, but, you know, it's kind of like 20% of one, maybe. You know, it's not communist. You know, you can do what you want and all that, but there's still some restrictions and all that. So, you know, really, the gameplay is really the perfect server, you know? That's how it be.
Well, there is a dude who's role-playing. Princeton Banks.
Yeah, there's a guy who does slash me. He says, pull your car over and all that crap. I don't understand how he does it. I really don't.
Is there really a person who does that right now?
Oh, yeah. There is.
Yeah, he's like the only person doing it too on this server, and yet he hasn't figured out that it's not how it works. Like, people are trying to tell him, like, dude, what are you doing? This is not roleplay server. It's just,
well, listen, it's 2020, you know, we're in a capitalist society, you know. I guess if you want to be an RP dude, you gotta be an RP dude, you know. Everybody's got their ways. Even though it wastes time for him, that's how he does it, you know?
Yeah, you can put this any way you want.
That's very true. So, when's the last time you actually played? Because, you know, you were very active in the old fag era. I wanted to see if you could compare the old fag era from 08-09 to the monstrosity we have right now.
Is it really that bad right now?
Not right now, in time of Corona. Actually, it has gone better.
I mean,
last month or something, but before that, I don't know.
That depends on what you want to quantify it as.
It's hard to say, like, what you mean by play, because, like, I'll hop on, like, every once in a while. Like, I'll do, like, 30 minutes every 2 weeks or something, but I don't think I've played a full week in, like, 8 years.
Damn.
What happens? Do you get bored before, or nothing to do, or tired of people? What happens?
There's probably three main reasons why I don't play as much right now. And one would just be the community that I was involved with is no longer here.
Yeah, that's a big thing.
Don't you think there's new people you should give a chance?
Oof.
That's tough. I'm too tired and old for that shit. Plus, I mean, the other part too is once you become an admin, the game changes. It's not the same.
In what it's way? True. You can pay your own ticket like Metal Face? Abuse?
It's more like I go on, random people PM me, most of the time they don't even know who I am. And then other times they either try to kiss my ass. So it's like, I don't even know who you are. Why are you randomly messaging me?
But hasn't that gotten better since, like, I mean, you're one of pretty old admins, I think. I think, like, new folk don't even know who you are. So I don't know, do they actually pester you that much? Because I would think, like, the new wave of admins, everyone knows who they are, but like a bit older admins, like some people have forgotten, or they haven't even known the old admins, so probably that could give you some space to breathe and to play the game.
It can, but on the other side of that, I get called a cheater.
That's true. People who don't know you, they either lick your ass or they think you're a cheater because they've never seen you before. That just shows the 15-year-oldness of some people. You know, how does it feel to say that, bro, just look at one random person on the server and be like, bro, listen, I started playing this server when you were 4 years old. Just how does that feel to you?
I don't even know how to acknowledge that right now. Because, like, you can't tell exactly. Like, on the server, you cannot tell how old somebody is because some of the people are so immature when they play.
It's very true. It's very true, you know. But, yeah, you did say something about the old community. I saw your screenshots. You know, lots of skeeters, lots of... Hold on.
I actually have a question because I'm trying to do little maths in my head. What is the age of a freshman in USA? Like 18? 19?
High school. I started playing when I was like 13, 14, and I'm 26 now.
Mm-hmm. Okay, then you're not that old. I thought you're older. Okay. You're not that old.
I mean, that doesn't change very much about, you know, he's probably been on the server since some people have been 4 years old, you know?
I mean, no, I didn't want to say that. Of course, he's been playing long and you have a bunch of kids playing this game, but mm-hmm. I'm just saying that, like, there's, like you said, he's era and the people he has played around are long gone. I understand that. But that doesn't mean, like, there's no old people left playing the game, you know?
I mean...
There's still people his age playing the game, I guess.
I don't know. It's a very small percentage. Like, he sent me a screenshot album of some of these people. Like, I see Cuico. Cuico's dead. No, he's not dead, but he's long gone.
You just scared me. I was like, is he really
dead? No, he's not.
Oh, you're his age, Roshan, no?
Yeah, I didn't mean, like, age as in literal age. I meant, like, you know, longevity in the server. You know what I mean? Because age, I mean, that's not really a thing I think about when I, you know, play the game and see how old fag you are, you know. You know, I see Brody, you know, Mice, Dunno, you know, all those names. A lot of names that Cash doesn't know, you know what I mean? But,
What the fuck I know?
Do you? Let me tell you my password then. Let me tell you my password then. All right, we just switched to LB. So I gotta type my password. You can't guess what my password is based on how I just typed it. Yeah, it's been a long time since all that, but you still come around, you still take a look at the Discord and all that. Is that really the only reason at this point to come back? You know, just to see the BMUKs and the, you know, the older people back on the server?
I mean, not always the older people. I feel like this is one of the communities where no one ever really leaves.
True. That's true. I can't
I like popping in saying hey. Like, I'll go on the server every once in a while, but usually I'm just fucking around, doing complaints, whatever.
Do you like doing complaints? Babysitting people?
Is that a serious question?
Yes!
Could go either way.
I don't know. I don't know, man. I actually have feelings. Some people like doing it, like cleaning away stuff. I don't know. I look at forums and I see, like, Marcus Reed going through, like, 20 posts at the time, like, on forums, and I'm thinking, part of him must like it. I mean, else he would just have stopped doing it, you know?
I get what you're saying, but it's kind of tough. I mean, if you look at that one person compared to, what is it, 80-something admins that we have?
By 100 now.
Yeah, true.
I'm not going to complain about complaints. Like, I volunteered for this. Like, I go on and I do it. But some of the complaints that you get are just ridiculous.
It's very true. In fact, there's this dude. He's PMing me right now. His name is Draco. Apparently, he got his ass banned or something. And I remember reading his comments. it had something to do with him being rightfully banned. Let me take a look at this shit right now, actually. Because he's PMing me right now, and he's, you know, prodding right now, and it's getting a bit annoying. But let's see here. So he says, "Yo, Roshan, I am Draco, and I got banned by anti-cheat in both servers because I copied some files to run my San Andreas smoother." Well, cocksucker. If you hadn't done that, which is probably most likely not allowed, well, we wouldn't need to have the conversation. You know, things like that don't really require an answer, in my opinion. You know,
what does he want? Get unbanned? Your sympathy?
To get unbanned, to get unbanned, my sympathy, and all that. This is not the time, you know. Some people...
Yeah, doesn't he know how important I am?
Yeah, exactly. See, well, here's the thing. Like, whenever somebody's got their problem, they, at that moment, feel like they are the most important at that time. And, you know, there are times where that is true. But you just got to look back at your request sometimes and be like, does this really make sense? And most of the time, they don't really not acknowledge that what they're saying makes no sense.
A couple weeks ago when I was playing, there were these two players that were just going back and forth, killing each other, and then complaining about each other.
Exactly.
To the point where I disabled them both for a day.
Exactly.
And then, you know, his quote-unquote friend came on and was like, "Hey, can my friend just, can he come on a unregistered account?" I'm like, "You're disabled for a day."
Exactly, like... It happens all the time now. There are people that DM each other and all this. You know, one mate legitimately get DM'd, but the guy who gets DM'd may be a DMer. And then it's like, you know, should I really intervene in this crap? Because he's just going to go on to attack the guy back. And it's like, okay, well, you just gave open invitation for the guy to attack you back that DM'd you. So it's basically a carousel of stupidity when looking at stuff as an admin, you know. And sometimes, you know, as Crazy Bob had said in the past, sometimes you just got to not intervene when it's that those types of people, you know. Let them settle their own differences, and in the end, it won't really matter shit. You know?
It's all the sexual tension they have with
each
other.
It's
you can
true.
Tell when that's DM each other back and forth. That's just flirting. You can tell.
It's true. I mean, it's all it is shooting bullets at each other. You know, it's a simulation. You know, instead of, you know, the other thing, they're shooting bullets at each other, you know. They have the long sawn-off, which is longer than the actual gun, and they're just shooting at each other. That's what it is, you know. They're just spreading love to each other, you know. They're spreading the genes, as we like to say, you know. But most of the time, they're not very compatible. So what do you do when they're not compatible? You just shoot more, you know. And in the end, they all go on a Ferris wheel. So that's the life of an admin, you know what I mean? I
understand. The weirdest shit or whatever that I lately heard is like, oh, I'm punished, but I don't agree with it. You remember that one, Oshan? Or there right. was like Xan or someone who got disabled and they're supposed to stay away from the server and they were like, yeah, but I don't agree with it, so I play anyway. It's like, what sort of person that has ever been disabled or banned has agreed with their ban?
Well, that guy's a complete badass. Like he should be undisabled. Like he should be an admin right now.
I don't know, man. He is like, Xan.
People can only punish me if I agree with it. Okay?
I mean, most of the time, 90% of the time, I know most percentages are made up on the spot, but most times when people get punished, obviously they don't agree with it. But you know, if you want to be a badass, I'll give you something to be a badass about. And Xan, he's a little kid. You know, he is one of the dudes that Hamchilla has played since he's been 4 years old. You know, Xan is like 16. He's, you know, he's Canadian, which is surprising. You know, he's an idiot. He got banned. He disagreed with the ban, and he's still banivated. And I don't think he got banned for that. I don't think he got banned for banivating for that. But, yeah, you know, some people are just badasses, you know. Some people will sit down and take their punishment, but some people will, you know, they'll rise, they'll protest like people are doing, as Kesh said before. You know, we want to go back to work and all that crap, and they won't wear their mask. That's just how some people are, you know, in the world of CNR. yeah, Hamchel, before we started the show, we talked about different voice chats and all that, you know, how they've evolved through the years. You talked about the old fag era, people were using Ventrilo and TeamSpeak. Who are those hosted by? Because I know Clap, the Clap Gang. Remember the Clap Gang, right? The Clap Gang had their Ventrilo with Azmurf and Jesus and whoever else is in the Clap Gang. Was there a CNR Ventrilo back then? Because I actually have no idea.
I think it was a Mumble. I think there was a CNR Mumble. I don't know what a Ventrilo.
Yeah, that was
going
on
Ventrilo once in a while.
Who was on there? Just, what, old fag dudes? Quico and Assassin and Skeeter and all that? Well, Skeeter didn't talk, he didn't, right?
Yeah, Skeeter doesn't talk.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's heard Skeeter's voice before.
I'm trying to think. I only randomly would go on there, and usually it was like people in like DMH would bully me to go on.
Oh, yeah, I got that too. Like one time to get on the CNR Mumble. No, it was the DMH Mumble. Because Metal Face had pestered me to get in DMH. And Euphoria one time was like, you know, he challenged my manhood. And he was like, I don't remember what he said exactly, but, you know, get this Roshan in the Mumble and all that. And I was like, damn, this dude, he's challenging my manhood. So I'm like, all right. Even though all I got is a crappy webcam mic, I'm like, all right. I got to get on this DMH Mumble, you know what I mean? And didn't look back. I didn't know how bad I sounded for like a year or 6 months, but I got on it, you know?
I don't think I ever talked. I just hopped on to do it, hearing people talk, and then they'd ask me questions and it would just be silence and response.
Not even a type back, like, you know, typing in the channel to reply to them. Just the silence, huh?
Just the silence.
Oh, well, I mean,
that's maybe an in-game PM.
That's really how it was, you know. When I first joined Mumble, didn't really want to speak. But
Shitfest, though.
Well,
there was way too many people talking at the same time and people screaming and stuff. I don't know. It was way more hectic than it is Discord these days. I feel like, at least.
Well, it's true. I mean, the thing about it is, you know, there are people who had their subsets of Mumble. You know, you had the DMH Mumble. Sam was probably too broke to have a Mumble, so they probably have been Trillo.
That hatred's still there a little bit.
Yeah, listen.
The salt is still real.
Sam is still a bunch of Warats, you know? It's a bunch of Warats. Do you remember Special?
Yes, I do.
Oh, yeah, that dude. What do you think about that dude? He was the best dude, man. He was the best troll in CNR's history.
Is he, though?
He was.
Was he a troll?
Yes, he was.
And the only reason why I ask, because there's someone else in my mind that I'm thinking, I don't know if he actually is a troll or if he's just that way. There's one player, I don't know if you can think who it is.
From that era?
I think he's still around.
I don't know.
He's a big forum person.
Crazy Driver.
No, I was thinking Play Too Hard.
Play Too Hard,
He doesn't think he thinks of himself as a troll. He would like to be taken seriously. People don't take him seriously.
He's a bit part troll, to be honest with you. He is a bit part troll. Like, he's usually serious, but there are just things that, you know, that he says that contradict what he condemns, you know? And that's really what I understand.
It's the way he formats his posts, too, that always got me. He got me. I don't usually fall for trolls, but whatever he's doing gets to me.
Yeah, I mean, also his big, large text, the wall of texts on the forums, you know, type of snit that you can't bother reading.
You know, you ever get a message from him, like a PM?
It's been a while, but he's made comments on my videos sometimes, and there are times where it's, you know, kind of trolly material, and he reacts to the trolly material, and it's like, bro, listen, this is satire, bro. You don't gotta make a 700-word essay about all this, you know. It's not necessarily, you know, criticizing anybody, or me, rather, but... He just revels in making novels, I guess. He just makes books, you know? He likes to write for a living, I guess. I have no idea. I don't know what it is. But yeah, Cash mentioned the CNR Mumble. That was a bit after that era. I remember you were in the CNR Mumble a little bit, and I think you could sense the amount of idiocy that was in it. You did talk a little bit in it, though.
When even was that? I can't even like pinpoint in my memory what timeline that is in.
Like 2013, 14, something like that. Like 2013 and 15.
Yeah, that probably makes sense. I probably popped in every once in a while.
Yeah. I don't know if you, because you can't pinpoint the time. I don't know if you remember the type of idiocy that was around that time. Because, you know, like I said. You know, the DMH Mumble and the Sam Mumble was a good thing because at least you could invite people that you want to be in it. You know, it's just like when you play CNR, most of the time you will converse with the people that you want to play with. But in the CNR Mumble, well, it was basically a melting pot of stupidity, you know, and it wasn't a good thing for a lot of people. And yeah.
That was the one that was just open to everyone, right?
It was open to everybody,
I'm remembering now. Okay, yeah, that was a shit show.
Yeah.
I retract my statement. I probably went in once or twice, and I was like, nope,
Yeah, she was Sphincter Benair. He made that mumble. You know, the dude from Florida with the funny laugh. Yeah, he was the one that made the mumble. But yeah, it was really a shit show.
Yeah. He would be the person to do that.
It's true. At the end, when Discord came about, he made the unofficial CNR Discord, and it pretty much was very similar. A lot of people who were just plain idiots going around. Don't gotta have that kind of energy around here, you know what I mean? But yeah, that's how it was. But I guess we already touched on what the community is now compared to what it was before. But I just want to get into the level of, you know, because these days when I go on the server, I look at chats, and it's like, bro, I'm losing brain cells, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but I try to think back at the chat in the past, because like CNO's always kind of been a shit show, no?
That's true. It's always been kind of snitty. Like now it seems like it's more of a, you know, broken English version of the past, you know, because back then people talked shit and it was really annoying.
But you could understand it?
You could understand it, yeah. That's the thing.
So you knew you were being talked shit about, whereas now you're just not sure?
Yeah, now you kind of have to laugh a little bit because, you know, the way people talk shit is, you know, it's broken and it's a bit funny, you know.
But it is funny, though. I mean, I don't...
A little bit.
I just think the most annoying thing is actually on rugs. Like... I don't know if it has always been like that with Onregs back in the days also, that people were just coming on Onregs to ruin everyone's fun, but I don't actually mind like regular shit talking, because if someone has something to tell you, it's okay, you know, if they're regular or whatever, but to hear things from people that know everything about you when they have like 2 score and you know they're like some regular talking on reg, that's annoying, at least to me.
Mm-hmm. Those guys gotta get that ass banned right away.
Get that ass banned.
See, if you come on reg and you start talking shit, that's some pussy shit right there, alright?
Yeah, that's what I don't like. Like, if you have something to say against some regular, or if you want to trash talk or whatever, why don't you come on your main and just, you know, man up and say what you have to say? It's pointless.
Because you're gonna kick his ass if he does. You're gonna go DM him.
I will not DM anyone. I mean, I'm not like really a fighty person, but it's just like, man, like most of the time those people talk a lot of trash, but like they have like 6 banned accounts or whatever, you know. So how does their opinion really matter?
Because they got banned because they're so good.
But yeah, Hemshaw, nobody was doing that back then. Nobody talked shit through unregs and all that. You know, if you play unreg, you were just messing around, you know, stealing cop cars, and or you were legitimately just new, you know. It's a bit more fluid back then.
Yeah, you had to keep your words to your name.
Exactly. There was a lot more self-worth back then, you know. Now it's just, you know... a creativity contest on the 50 unreg mains you can make. That's kind of a thing. But yeah, I am really trying to figure out if it was more toxic back in the old fag era or here. I mean, my thought was like the more intellect you have on the server, the more toxic it can be. I don't know. Because there's just a lot of people now that are just blissfully ignorant, and you know, they're just not as, you know, up there in the head. I don't know. I really don't know. I don't know what era is more toxic, you know.
I don't feel it was like less DM back then, because I remember when I came on server and I was like 2010, 11, something like that. 10 probably. When I first started playing, I didn't even know how to register and shit. I always got DM'd, always. At first, like, first 2 weeks, I think I was DM'd constantly. Probably people were just like, oh, this person is not registered, or they're just noob. Let's try to practice aim on them or something. So, I, like, I don't feel like it was always that welcoming CNR. It just probably was more nicer regulars around, and that made it better. I don't know. What do you think, Humchila?
I think that's kind of the case too, whereas people know when you're new that they can just kind of attack you for no reason, and you don't know how to even defend yourself or complain or whatever. Like, I see what you're saying, and I think it's traveling through now. Like, I think the amount of DMers percentage-wise have probably always been the same.
I mean, it's tough for me to really compare because, you know, being admin and not being admin, but, yeah, I mean, yeah, you're right. You know, the newer that you seem, the more likely that you're going to be DM'd. I mean, in the old fag era, I got DM'd, you know, quite a few times. When I got to like 2010, 11, I got DM'd a lot less and less, you know, so I guess it does have something to do with name value. But now, I don't really think people DM that often. It's just, if people DM, it's usually amongst themselves. Like, you know, if you're a DMer cocksucker and this guy over here is a DMer cocksucker, then the DMer cocksuckers fight each other, you know? It's more insular, I think, this, you know, in these times.
I got DM'd a lot in the past, and I still get DM'd now. I'm so bad at this game.
I'm DMing noobs as well, but I'm just raping them. Because it's so funny. I don't know. You know, when you rape same people over and over, and in the end, you kind of start to feel sorry for them, you know? And I message them, like, in PM, hey, buddy, like, if you don't want to get raped anymore, just buy condoms, you know, or take Advil or something.
Condoms don't prevent the rape.
I mean, yeah, but diseases, like, they wouldn't get diseases, you know, and they wouldn't die, like, from something simple as syphilis or whatever. I don't, like, usually have, like, the strong diseases anyway. I just tickle people. I don't, like, really take a lot of their health.
Sounds like you're talking you're raping people and then talking shit after.
But, like,
that's the equivalent of, like, killing someone and being like, get good.
No, but, like, literally, like, instead of them listening, you know, I'm giving them advice, they're like, fuck your mother, you know? Like, instead of they would listen and, you know, I'm trying to help them after all anyway, but they just don't care because they're newbies. It's funny.
Didn't you just talk about being, like, preyed upon when you were new and now you're doing the same thing?
I got raped like a lot of times, and then someone told me to buy condoms, and I did, you know. I didn't say like fuck your mother back, you know. Instead, like, I was like, hey, oh, okay, condoms exist in game, you know, for a reason. Probably it's just like some people are, I don't know, it's just like they don't have capacity to learn, you know. A lot of people in CNR, I feel like, I don't know.
No, they don't actually. I had that moment too. Hamchill, do you remember a dude named Irate Boys?
Sounds familiar.
I think he was one of my first encounters in CNR. Like, what I used to do was camp the PD when I was a new player. And Irate Boys would come around and he would rape me. And after a while, I'd die. And I just took that as normal. I'm like, okay, well, you know, I get raped by this dude and I die. I didn't know there was anything to, prevent against that. Yeah, prevent that. Yeah.
Here's a question I have, though. Was your skin a boy?
Yeah. Yeah.
Why didn't you just change your skin?
Listen.
I'm pretty sure he raped everyone. Stick to his name.
Well, he raped everybody, but, I don't play as a female character. Metal Face one time said the reason why I pick female skins is because I don't want to stare at a man's ass all day. But
that is so true.
Oh boy, listen, I don't pick my male skin to stare at its ass. All right, I just
what do you pick him to stare at?
The gameplay. I don't stare at my own skin. I may, you know, coincidentally look at my own skin, but I don't stare at it, and I don't, you know, that's not the entire point of it. I just pick the male skin. It's just a skin, you know, and I, you know, go about my business.
You're implying that Metal Fish is enjoying looking at the female skins?
He might. He might, yeah. Yeah. And if there's no problem with that, you know? Everybody plays CNR for what they want. And if he wants to stare at the skin, that's what he's going to do.
You can do anything you want to do on the server. It's up to you. It's your game.
Exactly. You're a female skin user?
Sometimes. Mm.
Why is this dude shooting me?
Don't bother that. I've got you. Sometimes... sometimes you're a female skin user. Right? Listen, I've never been a female skin user.
I'm never. Talking about skins, I'm actually, like, wondering what would happen if this game would be, like, a game that I talked about before. I don't know. You ever played it? It's called Scum. So, like, in game Scum, you can, like, create your own character you play with. But the bigger boobs you install to yourself or to your character, or the bigger dick, the smaller intelligence you have in a game.
What kind of game is this? I don't even pull over dick size.
No, seriously. So, there's always, like, you need to go for some sort of compromise, you know?
But why do you control the dick? What does the dick size have to do with gameplay?
Because it's like, it's, people can see it in the game, you know? It's like Rust. Have you ever played Rust where people are naked and they're running around? So some people choose to have big D, you know? But their intelligence in game is lower, so it takes them longer to craft stuff or whatever, you know? So, like, I was just, like, for a second wondering, like, if people could do actually that in CNR, I'm pretty sure you would have some dumb people that would go for it, you know? More
just,
pixels
just
and
huge
less
dong
intelligence.
Flopping around on CNR.
Pretty much.
All right. Anybody who plays Rust is a cocksucker. That's number one.
Play the Rust.
Then what's up, Lightpex? I know you're listening. You're a cocksucker. Okay, but
I have a question though. I'm Chila. Do you play any other games?
Other games besides CNR?
Yeah, or just.
Yes and no. Like, I'll pick up some. Like, I played The Outer Worlds last month. I enjoyed that. So, like, some RPG games I'll play. I got Animal Crossing because.
Oh, God.
Judge me as much as you want. It's nice and peaceful. It's relaxing.
Is it?
It is.
I saw a stream of it, but I don't know about that.
It's not. Other Rockstar games? I don't know. Red Dead Online or.
I didn't play online. I do have Red Dead 2. For some reason, I have not completed the story mode. I got caught up in, like, life. But the main games that I play, or at least the game, is I play Tekken. Like, the fighting game and stuff.
Yeah, I know. Who do you play against, though?
Like, just online.
Okay.
Yeah, ranked matches online.
Yeah, so, yeah, Red Dead's a long-ass game, so I wouldn't be... You know, it's not too much of a surprise they haven't finished. I haven't played online either, and, you know, I'm not really sure if I will, because, I don't know. I think I'd rather play GTA Online than, Red Dead Online, but I don't know, it's probably me.
Why? That's funny, like, Red Dead came out like, well, quite some time back now, and everyone was so hyped about it, but everyone is so not hyped about online for some reason. Yet when you ask people, they didn't even try it, you know? It's not like they tried it and they didn't like it, but no one has actually tried it, including me. Like, I have read it, but, like, I just have no interest trying online, and I don't even know why. Like,
I tried it a couple times. It was very slow. Like, there was nothing really to do in the world, and it was just slow. Even to get money, it was just very dragging on.
Wait, what's the game?
Red Dead 2 Online.
Oh. I mean, I don't know. I have no input on that. I still haven't made my character. People have been saying, "Hey, Rishana, when are you going to come into Red Dead Online?" And I'm like, I don't know. No idea. Maybe this weekend I'll make something. I have no idea.
What sort of character do you have in GTA 5 anyway, Sean? What are you?
What sort of character? What do you mean?
Yeah, everyone has like ridiculous. I don't know. I know, like, I play with Steppo sometimes, and he looks like some pimp with a bunch of tattoos and shit. Everyone looks so weird in that game. It's like people take it to extremes, you know, to look weird.
I don't know. I just look kind of normal. I think it looks like a bit Indian, but that's really, I don't want tattoos and that crap.
I haven't played GTA 5 online in years. Oh, probably before. I played CNR more than I played GTA 5.
I mean, that's probably true for a lot of us. I played GTA 5
for
a long time.
For some reason, I made myself Asian online. I don't know even why, but so yeah. I wish you could, like, I wish you could, sort of, well, we have a lot of clothing items and stuff in CNR, but it's like, you cannot, like, customize fully characters. Wasn't there a talk at some point that they would bring in more characters for people to use on CNR as well?
I think a lot of the skins are buggy, is what the issue was.
Yeah.
Still, same with, like, some interiors, too.
Yep.
Well, you know, I don't know. A lot of them are bugged, that's true. Crazy Bob, he added the Truth skin and the Macri skin, but they're bugged. But yeah, I'm not really sure why he added those two and not some of the other storyline skins. Like, I had the stance that everybody from the storyline of San Andreas, which I bet Crazy Bob didn't play. I think he said something he didn't play the storyline, but all the storyline skins should not be in the game, in the server, in my opinion. Just get him out of here. If you want to see him, play the fucking storyline. If not, play as an NPC. But that's me. That's me. So no more skins. That's my opinion.
Yeah, probably not. No more skins.
No more skins.
No.
What's your take on this latest update? Since you're like been in CNR for so long, like how did you like? I don't know, armored tires and vehicle and insta-fix and all that. Do you think it's too much or...?
When was that implemented? My timeline of this game.
I think it was like a few years now, no? Sure.
Let me see, I think, hold on. I think it was 2017, right?
Yeah, I think it's like it's 2017. 3 years. 2 or 3 years now, I think.
The big thing, the game is so different from when I started now that it's hard to compare them because, like, the idea of being able to fix your car right away or armored tires would be unheard of in, like, 2010.
That's right. That was the era of the cop tanks, man. Well, soon after was the era of the cop tanks.
Well, even with the cop tanks, like, before that, you weren't even able to car surf. Like,
oh, that's true. That's true.
That was an updated thing.
Yeah, that was a SAMP thing. SAMP allowed car surfing.
Because when I came like back to the game after being away, and this update happened, and then I first saw like InstaFix. To me, it was like, oh, regular players got admin command, you know, to fix the car instantly. You know? But you only get to use it once, and there's like a there's like delay in buying it, and there's a chance you can blow up. But it was literally like, oh, like every regular player got just the same thing as admins do have, you know, to fix their car instantly. And like at first, like to me, it was like completely overkill. I felt like it's way too strong and it shouldn't exist in the game.
I think the idea behind it was kind of prolonging like car chases or being more dramatic, I guess, you know, giving you another ace in the hole to keep the gameplay going. But I can also see on your end of it being just kind of weird.
Well, yeah, at the initial time, yeah.
Right now, I don't mind it because I'm thinking like, you know, like all those rate my chases that Roshan has recorded and just in general, yeah, like... all those chases would have probably ended like halfway through, if not before, you know, if it weren't like all for armored tires and the armored car and insta-fix and stuff, chases would end like very soon. But yeah, at the beginning it felt like, why is this in game, you know?
Car surfing, same kind of situation. Whereas I remember people being upset because now cops were doing that cop tank stuff and just hammering people down.
Yeah, car surfing did change the surfer a lot. You know, because when I was new and I jumped on a car, I was wondering, why can I stay on it? You couldn't single player, I'm pretty sure. Right? So, I mean, that just, back then it was just, you know, cops and robbers, you get in the car, maybe you have a passenger, you know. There was a ammo bug back then. Remember the ammo bug? If you bought too many, you know, if you bought too much ammo, you go in an interior and it goes down to 300. So it was a lot more regulated back then, you know. The bug made the game a bit more regulated. But,
speaking of bugs, right? I don't know how true this is, but yeah, I did look you up. I'm chilling a bit. So on Crazy Bob's fandom, you have your own profile site, and it says, Hamchila is a player on the CNR who spends most of his time fishing. The city he plays most is on LS. He was the second player to become the victim of a bug that results in the player receiving a massive amount of money for their birthday, 900 million instead of the usual 2 million, depending on how many people are playing on at the time and how much money they have. Is that true?
That's not only true, but if you go to the album I sent you, there's a screenshot in there of how much money I got.
How did that happen?
I literally have no idea. It was just a bug. It wasn't a known bug, but it was one of those bugs that like it happened before. Caused so many problems. I got attacked. We can go through the album. I have like a series of stuff that happened after I got that money.
How many PMs did you get daily by people? Come on, bro, give me 1 million. Just 1 million.
I gave out a decent amount of the money, but the issue was Mice at the time. I forget what gang he was a part of at that time. Do you know, Rashon?
Who's
Mice?
The fish thing? I know what you're talking about, but I forgot the name of it. There was a name. Like Panda was in it and all that.
Yeah. Anyways, that I kinda got shook down for my money after that by that whole group.
The admins take your money because it was bug? I mean, like, did they find out? Did someone do anything about it, or they just let you have it?
I think I only had the money in total for about a week.
What happened when the money reset?
No, I didn't get reset. Well, here's probably one of the bigger differences. Way back when, in CNR, if you died without life insurance, you got zeroed.
Oh yeah, it's true. It's true.
I got zeroed. I died.
How much did you cry? See, like those people these days, they cry. Oh, I didn't have life insurance. So I lost like 7 million. What's the feeling like when you die and you lose 900 million?
It was actual relief at that point because I was just being targeted. Like I'd go on the server. Here's the funny thing too is it was Mice, it was Dono, and it was Brody. The main people who are killing me in D-Brook. And I just, it was just constantly being attacked. And they were good. They would track me down and they just kill me. Like there's some screenshots in the album of that too. So finally when I got zeroed, I'm like, I don't have the money anymore. So I don't even care. Like, fuck it. I'm just going to go back to fishing.
Did they leave you alone after that?
I still got killed a few more times after because they still thought I had the money.
Where the fuck were admins at?
There were no admins back then. What
are you talking about? Where's that album? I want to see it. Where was it? Did you drop it here in the channel?
I sent it to Rashon. You want from the general?
Yeah, I'll post it in the chat. Yeah.
Here's the weird thing is people complain about the ad. Like I understand that admins should be online and like actively playing, but like back in the day, you might see an admin like. Once a month, like just that's one true. Admin.
Yeah, when I played, there were not many admins a lot on at the time. So, people now they're getting spoiled, cocksucker. Yeah, it's foil.
You think if people became pussified, or like they don't deal with the problems they should, or what's the difference?
I'd say that the difference is probably because there was a lot more self-reliance back in the day, whereas now I think players like seeing like their enemies get punished. I think that's what they look forward to, not actually killing them, but seeing them get punished.
True. I mean, in certain way, you know, well, Chibo would have certainly opinion on that, right? Because Chibo is like, oh, this is cops and robbers. Like, you should be able to, you know, you should stand for your own and fight people who DM you. Just DM them back or shoot them back, you know? But on the other hand, like, I also have opinion about that, you know, in the way that this server should also, like, I don't know, like, not support only one sort of players, you know? If you want to play in peace and you're a sort of player like me who doesn't like fighting, who doesn't like shooting, at least not in this game, then why can I not have that, you know? There should be tools available for those players as well, you know, that they don't have to fight if they're DM like constantly and I don't want to fight back. Like, why shouldn't I have option to complain and just get rid of the person that's DMing me, you know? So I don't know, I think like it's a mixture of both things probably. Like I think both type of players should be able to coexist, you know, on server. But yeah, probably like people have become less self-reliant and they just rely more on admins these days.
I agree with you. I also don't kill people. Like I'm terrible at killing people. I fished, I'd truck. So like when I did get DM'd, it was annoying. Like when I was looking at these screenshots for this, I found so many that like I took just to make complaints, but I never actually made the complaints on the forums. But I just have a ton of just me dying.
A dying montage, huh?
Aww.
Yeah, it was tough
dying
out there.
Dying,
you know?
Montage.
Yeah.
Someone should make that.
That's a good idea. I mean, back then, you know, the normal fishing areas like in Bayside and north of Montgomery, that's pretty popular. It was popular. But what I used to do, like I used to go out in Paradiso, like those docks out there, I just would go west off the shore. So if somebody were to come DM, they'd have to actually drive or, you know, go on the water, get a boat and drive out 2 minutes to get me. And if it was worth your time to do so, well, then you're a fucking asshole, really.
That seems like the most inefficient way to fish.
I mean, yeah, listen. It was compared to, you know, people fishing like under fish sale points, but listen, it was great. You go out there, you look at the water, you know, it was so, you know, you sit back, it was so, you know, great. It was so great. You can look at chat while you fish, you don't get bothered, there's no shoreline. It's inefficient, but it was great, I'm telling you. It was fucking great, so gotta put some respect on that.
Have you ever used Fishlog? I'm chill.
What did you say?
If you ever used Fishlog
for fishing. No.
Owned.
I strictly just tapping two.
See, that's what these new bitches don't understand, alright? You know, Kesh is over here trying to tell me that everybody once in their life has used Fishlog. And I'm like, listen, it's a tool for lazy bitches, all right? The more that you fish, the more that you get a feel of whether or not you should, throw away a fish. And if you fished for a very long time and you don't know that, well, guess what? You're a fucking bitch, and that's what it is.
I didn't say everyone that has ever fished has used Fishlog. Everyone that has ever gone to university and left their laptop on to fish in the meantime, they have used Fishlog. You know? Because as long as you're... It's not like the point of laziness. When you're there, why would you have software do things for you when you're there? You know?
Right,
you can first
do
of it
all,
yourself. But if you're not there, then, you know...
Okay, but what if you're not there and you get DM'd?
See, that's why I didn't, like, it didn't last. I didn't use it in the end, you know? Because what I did was, like, I was like, hey, man, like, I go to university all afternoon, you know, and I don't have money in game. And this time I could fish, you know, and I was like, yeah, but I can't fish if I'm not on PC. So I'm like, OK, I will just leave fish log on and I'll fish for me. I'll come home and I'll sell the fish, you know. And then what happened was I got DM'd like 5 times in the time I was away from laptop. And of course, it wasn't worth it in the end, you know. So I was like, yeah, this totally doesn't work. Screw it, you know. I will not fish in this matter, like in this method or this way, you know.
Exactly.
So in the end, it doesn't work. Like, I don't understand, like, who uses fish log. Because if you're there, if you're on laptop and you're fishing, or if you're on PC, then you'll fish on your own to keep yourself, like, engaged or whatever, you know? Mm-hmm. And if you're not there, you'll get DM'd anyway. So, like, what's the point?
Yeah, I don't know.
You're the one who brought it up. I said, I mean,
that's why I ask you, like, if you ever used it or not. I mean, I know it exists and people say they don't use it, but it must exist for someone. I mean, it was probably made for a reason.
That is true.
I don't know. When you say that, I have no idea. I mean, whenever I fish, I'm usually around the PC at the same time.
Yo, Rashawn, come here, check this. Noobies.
What am I supposed to check? What is your ID? I have no idea.
That's why I like...
48. The fun of... Where are the newbies?
There's helicopter above me with four cups. When's the last time you've seen four cups in a helicopter? It warms my heart.
Not a long time. That reminds me of the Jefferson Motel DM time. Remember that, Angela?
That was a very interesting time.
It was. It really was. I mean, I don't see why people don't do it today. I mean, it was frowned upon. You were really against that, I remember.
I had a few good times in there, but I suck at killing people.
I mean, it was like, you know, to look inside Jefferson Motel, see like 10 warrants inside there, and you go as a cop one by one to suicide, trying to get an arrest. And it's even tougher now because, you know, lag shot is gone. You know, if there was still a lag shot, you could at least, have a chance for people to miss, even though there were like 10 people shooting at you. But, cops really did get engaged. With the Jefferson Hotel thing, though.
It was a good, fun back and forth. I remember being told to go in there because I was a medic, and they would just buy drugs and heals for me. They didn't actually want anything else. They just wanted me to help them heal.
Yeah, and you can be in there and watch the action right in front of you. That's the best part, actually.
It's the white car! Some stupid admin messed up smiley.
You see, Hamshilla, when you're around here, you gotta endure the cash squeaks. There are at least two or three squeaks per show.
Someone's fucking with your car?
Yeah, they put something on my car and then it's not drivable. I swear to God, I'm a good driver. It's just the car. It's like there's something under it.
Oh, yeah, there's something on the car, alright.
Yes.
The one you're choosing.
You were talking about Jefferson Hotel and DM. Well, you said you're not much of DMer, but it has to be asked. Did you like Lekchot era more than after Lekchot, or not?
It really made no difference to me. It just made it quicker for me to die.
Well, I guess you still like Lekchot more.
I didn't eat, like. I'm so bad at killing people that the reason why I picked medic as a skill was so I could heal myself.
Wow. I never played as a medic, I don't think. That's one thing I haven't done in this game. Because I feel like it's... I don't know how many people to actually buy $500 heal. Like, everyone just takes drugs or, you know...
Well, that's where you made the money. Usually what I'd do back in the day, it would be I'd post up at jail... An assassin and sheepfucker would be just raping people relentlessly, and they would just be buying drugs for me. I'd just be making bank.
Because, like,
fucking dead.
I don't know, everyone hates medics, and then, like, rapists as well, if you heal them, like, they will put a hit contract on you, or, you know.
I was a private medic, not a public. So, like, I couldn't force a heal. I could sell drugs, though.
Yeah, you're a civilian medic. Yeah, yeah. That's how you could help with the...
I don't know. When I'm rapist, I hate medics. I'm like, get away.
I mean, there aren't many people who are police medics these days. You know?
Was B-Bird the last one?
B-Bird, I think, was the last major one that actually went around and healed non-SAM members, obviously.
Non-SAM? He, like, selective?
Yeah, B-Bird is the token North American SAM member.
I know who B-Bird is, but I didn't know, like, I don't know his gang alliances or whatever.
Well, he got DM'd a lot of times by DMH back in the day.
He was an easy target.
He was an easy target. He made a lot of complaints.
Do you remember Gumile?
Gumile, yeah. I remember him.
Newborn.
Oh god, that dude.
I remember Newborn makes music or something. He made this song and he was just like, B-Bird is a faggot. B-Bird is a faggot.
I think I remember that too. Newborn was he was a high tier troll, I'm telling you. Back in the day when people put on the Dolan avatar. That was the Finnish thing before all these new fag Finnish PL players came in. I don't know where Newborn's from, but still a lot of people have the Dolan avatar, but he was a big ass troll. But yeah, B-Bird, he took it up the ass a lot for curing people back then, you know. So
people be pissed because they'd buy like syphilis from me for like 10 grand and then B-Bird would come along and cure it.
That's right. I mean, see, it's probably the most disrespectful or the action that's taken the most disrespectfully as far as, you know, the script of the server, you know. If you cure my diseases, oh, cocksucker, I'm about to go get you. You're about to die 5 times, you know. Because I remember I did that. I cured Kona Mila, and I was curing Mafia Latina members. And I tell you, man, they all went for me. They all destroyed my ass, I'm telling you. So it's a tough thing.
Speaking of the Mafia Latina, I don't know. Little fun fact, but I was the first and like only non-Spanish speaking member of that group. Before I was in DMH, I was in the Mafia Latina for some reason.
DMH Mafia Latina, they kind of had like a little partnership a little bit, right?
I think eventually. Yeah. What happened was I'd fish in Palomino Creek and that's where they'd have their gang wars, and eventually they just protected me.
Yeah, and back then you had to have some protection, you know, with all that DM going on.
Is that why I joined DMH, Sean? Because either you would get DM'd by...
Does anybody really join DMH? I feel like it's, like, forced upon you.
It is forced upon you, yeah, it is. They come looking for you. You don't join, they come looking for you. That's what it is. That's the special thing about DMH, you know. Metal Face came looking for me. And after that, it was history, you know. Other Ganags, like, they just do it the normal way, you know. Sam recruits Borats, Mafia Latina, all you gotta be is Latino. But DMH, they
That's
come
not
looking
true.
For you.
I'm not
well, except for you. Except for you.
I'm that special.
Except for you. Being around Quico and the Nahara brothers and freaking CEO, who turned out to be a cheater, I think. Yeah, a lot of old names back then, you know what I mean? But, yeah, you had to have some protection back then, and that was the thing.
Super Sean, I was never in any groups or any gangs or anything, because I hated them. But if you had to put me in one group, like, naturally, as a personality or something, what group you think you would fit me the most?
Well... I'd probably say the old-time San Fierro hooligans, because everybody in that ganag, you know, they were on the come-up. Oh, jeez, another fucking birthday. They were all on the come-up, and then as time went on, they all morphed. into other things. I think Alexi was in there, Dr. Friday, Sarust.
A lot of the
Dutch dudes were in there.
You know that I don't like any of whatever. You would put me with people that I don't get along with.
I mean, back in 20... What year was it? Back in like 2013, you probably would have. I don't know. SFH number one. See, Colgate. Alexi was in that. Snitz, you know. They brought the Ganag lifestyle to San Fierro. LCN. Fuck out of here. What was that? Pedro 2MP? He made that shit? That dude was a bit bipolar.
I was actually invited to a group.
Which one?
I didn't want to join.
Happy Tree Friends?
No.
There was another
Black
group.
Black Mother.
It was like a social gang. It was love. It was the heart symbol. That's probably what you would fall into.
Yeah.
What do you think? Would Sinisha make me a good cop?
No.
Sinisha, no. Or however you call him?
No. That guy's a fucking idiot.
I dodged a bullet not yeah. joining Blackwater.
Yeah, and Borland was in it too. But yeah, they're, you know, wasn't Panda in those, you know, the fish gang and the heart gang, not gang, but group, the social group. Yeah, there were social groups back then, yeah. There were Happy Tree Friends and that. Panda was in it, yeah.
I think what happened was there was fish, and there was that whole issue with the whole, like, fish slapping bug that would automatically kill people. So that got disbanded, and then from that group became that heart group.
Yeah, like I said before, you know, Panda was in that snitz. I tell you, man, if there's a player that I miss the most on this server, it's definitely Panda.
Absolutely.
Definitely Panda.
I think I was in-game married to her, too. Like, I think I have a screenshot of our wedding. Let me see if I can find it.
I'd like to see that snit. That'll be part of your album for sure. You probably didn't put it in the album, but it definitely has to be in it.
No, I got it. I found it.
Let me see that snit.
It's probably like 10 ways down.
Oh, it's in the album.
Yeah, so it's me, Panda, Ray, Zero is the priest, and then like somebody's over on a cow.
Wow.
Oh boy, a fucking... In-game, you know, Rayo, he actually suggested a marriage in CNR.
There was a time when a lot of people were requesting, like, marriage to be added to CNR.
Oh, shit, I feel like I was there, what the fuck? Yeah, you see the picture?
I think a lot of people were saying that it was too, like, RP-ish.
Yeah, I mean, the thing about it is that if you add it, then you have to have features surrounded around it.
True.
So, you know, it could be just a meme-y thing, but I don't know. It has to have some content. But, yeah.
I miss Panda, too. She knew how to have a good time and, like, just make something from nothing. Like, I don't know how she did it, but there was always something to do when she was around.
That's true. Panda was one of the original people who, you know, made a bunch of those, you know, construction things around the cities. I remember one in Los Santos, you know, Kyle Smith got butt mad because Panda and Kyle Smith didn't really like each other, and I think he snitched to deplete it. But still, Panda was one of the most fun admins on the server, and, you know, Panda being gone is probably the reason why I don't know how to do any object crap, you know.
Even before she was admin, I don't know how she would do it, but she'd be able to grab an admin, tell the admin to, like, make any object she'd want. Like, she'd be like, put it this place, do it this, you know, put a big cow in the sky above Las Venturas, make it move slowly down the strip, and we're going to be on top. She'd always have ideas to do, even if she didn't have the power to do it. I don't know how she'd do it.
That's true. She was a visionary.
Imagination. I guess. I don't know.
I mean, if she was still admin, then, you know, could see a lot of construction, you know. But
was she said to be a mentor, Sean?
Yeah, she would have been my admin mentor. You know, both of my prospective admin mentors both got demoted. So, crazy.
Who was your mentor, Angela?
We had mentors?
Thinking about it now. I don't know. I don't know the man.
I don't think I got assigned one.
There's no one to hold your hand.
I don't even think Crazy Bob knows I'm an admin. I've never really talked to
him. Owned. Yeah, I mean, yeah, Panda or Andromeda would have been my admin mentor, but since they both got fucked, I had to learn on my own. Yeah, I mean, so no one held your hand when you got admin?
Probably not. I mean, I'm sure I played with Skeeter a bit, but I think the funny thing is, if you look at the people who I was around throughout the years, like, everyone just became admin eventually. So, like, whenever I logged on, it was just hanging out with other admins, and I don't think I had a specific mentor, but we all knew each other, we were friendly.
Yeah, that's true, that's true. I mean, you know, the players that you, lack of better phrase, grew up playing with, you know, they evolved into that, and, you know, you all grew together, it felt like. That's a bit weird to say, for me to say that, but yeah, that's how it be. I'm going to take a break here. I'm going to take a couple minute break. After we come back, I've got some, you know, usually when we do these interviews, you know, the thought is to dig up dirt on people, but you don't have any. So, obviously you remember the old forum, which you like to post on every once in a while to this day. We're going to get some screenshots of posts you made back in 2009, back when you were a baddie. And we're going to try to see what you were thinking back then. So
fucking bring it on, because I don't even know. I'm sure there's some weird shit I posted.
A little bit. Not that bad. But we'll talk about that. We'll be back on the CNR radio interview session. I got to restart the radio because the same thing happened as last week. Somehow the fucking music ain't playing in the background. Fucking virtual gauges, piece of shit. But we'll be right back. Also, shout out to Alexander, yo, 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 one of the shout outs. Shout out to Street Gang. Yeah. But yeah, there's a lot of content in the back. Yeah, yes, we are live. But,
what?
Listen, no, the...
I'm happy you asked because I was wondering too.
but yeah, you know, when I was a new player, I didn't really know anybody. Like, I played in, like, 2009 for quite a while after getting raped by irate boys 2 years prior. So I didn't really, I remember some of the names from back then. You had Propugnator and Assassin, all those dudes, and blah, blah, blah. But I didn't really know anybody, you know. And I had, like, 7 FPS. So after a while, I quit the server. Came back in 2009 after mini missions closed down. Still didn't really know anybody. It wasn't until, like, 2011 until, you know, I started to know people, and that was around the time of the DMH thing and the cop tank thing, so it was a big transition, you know.
I was one of those people who thought you and Ricard were a thing, I will admit.
Get him out of here. See, here's the thing, here, Chilla, listen. People be thinking that if people are in the same car doing the same thing, that it means something, you know?
It usually does, though. I mean, there have been a few couples. Like, I've seen it.
You've seen it, yeah.
Have you ever been associated with some of the, or...
I mean, technically I was married to Panda, but not any, like, no. Nah. Like, there's nothing going on anywhere with anybody with me.
No, you stayed safe. That's how you gotta stay safe.
Do you think all CNR girls, there's something wrong with them?
Every CNR player.
Yeah. That's true. There's something wrong with every CNR player. That's very true, actually.
We talked about this before we started. Like, if you said, like, oh yeah, I'm the best rapist in the city, people will look at you like you're fucking crazy.
Yeah, you get the cops called on you. Here. It only makes sense on this server. Everywhere else, if you replicate what you do on this server somewhere else, well, you got a real problem, bucko. You know,
did you ever play this game with someone from like real life? I don't know, like a lot of people on CNR, they play like with cousins, buddies, friends, I don't know, brothers, sisters, dogs, even cats. I don't know, cats are always playing when they're abusing.
Yeah, those cats, the cat put cheats on my computer.
Yeah, remember the time Captain John had the goldfish DM somebody?
So have you ever played with other, like, people in real life or something?
I've tried to get, like, two of my friends to play, like, way back in the past, but pretty much they went on for, like, one city, like, they played around for a little bit and then, like, never ever again.
Owned.
It's a bit deflecting, isn't it? Like, I mean, deflecting. It's like deflating, sorry. Feeling, isn't it? Like, because I don't know, you think it's fun and there's so much things to do in game and stuff, and then you show it to someone and they, like, play one city or something and then they get bored with it. Then you start to think, wait, is it actually boring or am I just a weird person or...
The game is hard to enter, and if you bring somebody into it, you have to explain a lot of it, because a lot of the stuff that you learn goes into the gameplay.
True. There's a lot of commands and stuff, and I don't know, like, it seems like common sense to us and common knowledge, but I think it's, like, a lot at the beginning.
The commands, I think, are the big one.
I still remember, like, back in the days on forums, there used to be so many topics and posts, and, like, most of the things on forums were, like, tutorials on how to fish, how to truck, how to this, how to that, how to do, and I'm always like, where are those topics gone? Like, I can't even, like, see them these days anymore.
I think those were mostly people trying to get, like, admin points, to be honest. I think I made one, too.
Well, it worked.
I think I did too. I don't remember, actually. But yeah, that's how it was back then. You know, you had a comprehensive guide. But let's move on to this album right here, right? That you wanted to talk about. Then we'll get into the what was Hamchilla thinking segment. So this will go one by one, top to bottom, huh?
Yeah, we can go through a few of these. But that, I mean, we've covered some of it already. But that first one with Jimmy Page and. That's the Mafia Latina in Palomino Creek. That was my hometown. That was my home base.
Yeah, if you had Quico, what's this fucking guy's name? Suicide Shiite. Shite Bomber. Good fucking dude. Yeah. Protected by all these bitches up in Palomino Creek. Second screenshot was Mrs. Money. That's not me, definitely.
I just had to give a shout out. She was great to fish with. I don't know where the hell she is now. But just shout out to Mrs. Money.
Yeah, shout out to Mrs. Money. She was a good player. GG for that. Let's see, third one here. You're falling down, probably health hacking to fall down so you don't die. This is back when the kill list was a bit less detailed. You got Juicy in the chat, or in the kill list right there, getting the kill. How about that? See, was talking about another CNR couple. You had Juicy on a royalty and fucking, what was his name, Rezzer? Remember that?
I thought it was Carl.
What? Oh, no. Yeah, well, yeah, at first it was Carl, yeah.
There's another couple, there's an old couple in here that it might cause some shit, but what this screenshot is about, if you look in the chat, that was the birthday bug. So, Cash, if you want to see how much money I got, the next, like, few screenshots are about that.
I saw the next one. Paid, total paid from pocket, paid from bank. I don't know if I can compute that many numbers. I don't know where to start.
That's pretty bad. The one after that is my financial statement of how much money I had at that point.
That's a lot of numbers. Damn.
You got a $324 million tax. GG. And oh, damn, look at the distribution center from that one. I mean, not even 5 minutes later. After you get your first birthday there, you're in the house called Shit Shack, obviously. And you got 7-8 people getting that cash. This was back when you could freely distribute money. It was good times back then, you know?
You can't do that anymore?
Well, you can, but to a certain extent. I think there's a limit. It's probably a millionaire or something like that.
How was this dude never made admin, or was he? Pleox?
Pleox?
Yeah. Oh. He's a really old player, I don't know.
Does he still play? I assume he just kind of faded out, like most people do.
I can swear I saw him somewhere a couple months ago, on the forum or in Discord or something. Like, more likely the forum, but he doesn't play anymore. I don't know, you know why no admin or whatever, but I don't know. He kind of reminded me of a more chill King Icarus, I guess.
Don't think he was like problematic or something. No,
he wasn't problematic that much. Yeah. Next screenshot, we see Ham Chill talking about the weapons in City Hall getting destroyed, maybe by Brody.
He's getting destroyed in the picture.
Yep,
this is when they came after me for the money. So Brody don't know mice. They came after me and demanded like a payment from the money that I just got.
There is, man, the DMH tax, mobile tax. That's what it was back then. You get killed, then they meet you at the tennis courts in Vinewood. They kill you again. Dead is dead. Lots of dead is dead going on right there. Next few screenshots. So. Tell you, man, it wasn't a great pickle back then to be DM'd, because as we said, there weren't as many admins back then. You know, you talk about, oh, guys, you know, we don't see an admin here, there's no admin on all day. Well, listen, this was pretty normal back then, so y'all getting baby.
Look at that name. There's a first screenshot with modern era kill feed. There's a dude named Cumshot Unicorn.
Help. And then,
I guess people were trolling back then too.
Yeah, in one of these screenshots, this guy is named TTI458. He did slash me, and he says that he comes on ZZ Bay face, then ZZ Bay opens his mouth, then Skeeter opens his mouth and stands next to ZZ Bay. So people back then had quite an imagination, I guess.
That's why you can't bring your friends on this game.
Yeah, they'll think that you're a fucking psychopath or some shit.
There's another screenshot we'll get to where it's like a piss party. Like, oh, if God. I had to explain that to somebody, I'd be like, this is completely like some weird fetish game that I play where we piss on each other virtually.
Oh, no. Only in CNR, I tell ya. Next screenshot, we'll get to that, I guess, but next screenshot is where you talked about getting married at the tall-ass building in Los Santos with Panda. We see Furtican in the background, too.
Like girl skin, man. Two girls getting married.
Yeah, I mean,
it's like I'm progressive.
Progressive.
Come on.
Listen, Hamchilla, he likes the female skin, so, you know, you just gotta see what's behind the keyboard, you know what I mean? Zombie. I guess the next screenshot is, you know, after the honeymoon, like 2 hours after.
No, I think this was a completely different day. There's a few screenshots here that go together, and the car chase of this was just, it was fun to be a part of, but it was like the screenshots I got were pretty cool too.
Promising Pope and Lady Love Lashes.
Where you see that?
The one. Oh, after the next the wedding. One. Oh. I like those screenshots because when you like try to zoom them in and open them up, resolution is 800x600.
Well, I mean that's how I was back then.
Why are you talking shit? Do you know how hard it was for me to
owned? Also,
yes.
Yeah, 10 FPS. Also, JNB was on the car. JNB, probably the first Slovenian to play on the server. EG. Did you know that, Kesh? He's Slovenian. Yeah, JNB.
Yeah, show some respect.
Yeah. Show some respect.
I always stayed away from Slovenians, especially when I started playing the game, because I didn't really like Slovenians. I thought they were all idiots, to be honest. But we had some resurgence lately with Clapson, though. He's dead, I think. He's gone. Fags is around. Agent M.
Well,
I don't know. There's variety.
Well, all those people were born from JNB. JNB is the OG Slovenian player. And he's also an otaku. But that? Who would have thought? A Borat otaku. I never thought of that before.
Who would have thought?
What is that?
I didn't know for JNB that he's Slovenian. I didn't know.
I didn't know
but
that.
But the first Slovenian I knew on the game was Money, and I really didn't like
him. Jesus. Let's not get to that.
And I think there was like Prik Moritz or something, but he was
who?
Not a good player. The dude with number 3 in his name.
What's his name? I actually have no idea.
Something like that. He was in some gang or something.
Oh, yeah, I remember that dude.
Yeah.
I didn't know he was.
But he was, I think he was DMing a lot.
Gee. A country of 50,000 people, and yet they all are DMs. Next screenshot here, you got JNB. Oh, this is back in the, the Cardsurf days. You're getting the three blind mice right there, Juicy and fucking Carl too, back when they were on good terms. Who won that fight, by the way?
There was a fight?
I mean, did you guys tell him?
I have some old couples in my mind that are probably not together anymore, but they're still in my mind they are.
Yeah, I mean, Juicy and Carl were a big one, but yeah, I'm talking about the screenshot where you, Panda, Rayo, and JNB, y'all fighting Juicy and Carl too. Still in that Broadway. It's old times right there. Didn't they, they got into some trouble together, didn't they? Well, not together, but something that break them up. They got into some big trouble.
No idea. All I know is from these screenshots, I finally got a kill. And then Panda and JNB and Rayo were protecting me from Juicy and Carl. And I just love the screenshots of it.
That's a great snapshot of that snip. Let's see here. Next one. You guys are in the train tracks. Got Tater Salad, Skeeter, Sheepfucka, and Bond, James Bond. Holy shit, that's that name I haven't seen for a long ass time. It's a very dumb name, so it's not very tough to forget. Wait, hold on. It's not tough to remember.
But yeah. I just have a bunch of like the trains, because that was probably one of the first like really big updates to the game. Like once trains got in the game, like they're kind of boring now, but that first like week that they're out, people were just fucking around them all the time.
Yeah, man, you gotta
trying to stop them from there, just putting everything in front of them.
Gotta go fast, too. Yeah, go 20 miles per hour on a fucking train, bring you through San Andreas and the Jiffy. This one here was a lot of. Oh yeah, you did that. You guys did that. You had the coaches and the cement truck trying to block the train.
Yeah.
Nice fucking snapshot of that. Also in chat, JFTW and Tater Salad destroy you back to back, and you died the third time. So you had you had three deaths in the same death list.
Like I said, that's probably the best skill I'm good at, is just dying.
Oh man, it's gotta get annoying after a while, can't it?
Actually, so in San Fierro, what I do with that life is I just see how much I can die as quick as I can. My score is like negative like 1500 right now. And I'm like 3 million in debt.
Oh boy. You ain't getting out of that unless you win the lotto, which
I'm not trying. I want to get that as much debt as I possibly can. That's my goal. That's how I have to play these days. It's fucked up.
Who was that player that there was a forum post a few years ago, I think, from you or someone tried to help him because he was always in debt and negative score and people were asked to donate for him?
Share Robber?
No, someone else. Forgot.
Actually, I have no idea. I think I know what you're talking about, but I don't know who the person was, you know? Mew back then, very giving player. But she was definitely on the old fag era with money. Let's see here, another screenshot of y'all trying to block the train. Y'all had like 10 fucking cars to block the fucking train. And a fucking capsized coach, holy shit.
That was like the first day it came out. But a lot of these were trains, like, you just had to be there for it. Like, it was one of those special moments in time where the server got a big update and everybody just wanted to experience it.
Like a snapshot in time. This was back when Sis had his old name. Moogie, fucking done. Yeah, Mookie, that guy's a fucking dick. Let's see. This time y'all are on. Okay, see a screenshot here. Sunday, 11:32. Y'all were on the train.
I remember
going
this
to Los Santos.
Zibart, the cop.
Oh, Zibart, yeah. It's a fucking, mouse. I think he's one of the youngest admins ever, I think.
I think Mika was the youngest. Mika's like my age, and he was an admin before I even got on the server.
Mika the ass, the mop head?
That he is.
Yeah, he was a cool dude.
I think, I got kind of close to him. I think it's weird. I think I have his number.
I think there was a rumor that you two were, you know.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Dudes.
Yeah.
50% probably true.
There's nothing wrong with that at all. Mike Meek of the Ass was a fucking bounce as well. I think he met Metal Face and some other dude in New York one time. It's kind of funny.
No, do you ever meet up with anyone from CNR in real life?
I haven't. I mean, there'd probably be a couple people I would hang out with, but I don't think nobody's close. Mika's probably one of them. Probably Mika and Myth I'd probably hang out with.
Yeah, Myth, that dude's a fucking riot. So, yeah. Oh, well, let's see here. Oh shit, Alpha. That dude's a fucking boss, man. Like, he's one of the first people that got me in the scene. Alpha getting DM'd or killed by Exit. Oh, it's Hit Contract, I meant, not DM. He got killed for Hit Contract. Alpha's a fucking boss. He, was one of the best drivers back then. Remember Alpha, right?
I do.
Yeah, he's a fucking boss. That guy was the number one dude for me in the old fag era. Let's see here. Exit was probably like 12 in the screenshot. Let's see. Just imagine how Exit sounds like right now and how he sounded like back then, 2009. Let's see here. Next one, you're in jail, and, you know, if this was in a movie where you're being stared down by three dudes in a jail cell and you're a woman, well...
Peter and Xander, what can you possibly wish for that would be worth?
That was when Xantar and Skeeter were not admins, but Assassin was.
Oh boy.
And I guess now it's reversed.
Oh yeah, what a story. What a story about Assassin right there, man. I'm telling you. Let's see. Next one on the pirate ship. Got six punks here. Rayo trying to fall to his death, but he can't fall to his death here.
This is what I was talking about. Like, Panda wasn't an admin at this time, but she was definitely making Skeeter do whatever it is that she wanted to happen.
Don't blame her. Don't fucking blame her. Gotta make some fucking events out of here. Oh, shit, next screenshot, the one you talked about, the piss party. Yeah, who's at the bottom?
How do you explain this to someone?
Is that Ninu?
I think it is, yeah. This is probably when she just got admin.
What a fucking initiation, huh?
That was when, before, like, now we usually see, like, the groups of admin getting promoted, but way back when it was just, like, it was, like, one person at a time.
Yeah, because now it takes a long time for a Crazy Bob to look at the list if he even doesn't tick people off.
Mm-hmm.
Back then, I guess he was still active and he could, like, promote every day. I mean, I don't know if he knew people. Yeah. Did you get this sort of initiation as well, or Sean?
No, I was made admin with like 8 other people, so I don't think there really was
a piss initiation. Party of your own?
No, I would never approve of a piss party. Absolutely not. That is definitely not.
Oh, definitely not. Here we go. Next one. Dry Lake?
Let me see Dry Lake. Oh! I thought you meant. Well, the next one was Bambi next to a road train, with Ham.
Did you know Bambi?
Oh. Yeah, Bambi long gone now, huh?
Yeah, she's like, I don't think those kind of players get enough credit, but she consistently just went on the server. She trucked. She didn't cause any problems. Like, she just enjoyed playing. And like, I'm sure there's players that do that now, but they don't get recognized from it. So just shout out to Bambi.
No, not as much.
Rensor, for example.
Yeah, Rensor, he's a trucker these days.
Yeah.
Let's see. Dry Leg?
Fucking look for money.
Cyclical, who turned out to be a cheater? We'll suck for money. Fugazi Fanta's bro? Who used Fugazi Fanta's account? Is that an account, EG? Rezzer, who turned out to be Juicy's next boy on the server? I think he got burned for that, obviously. I don't remember the terms of that, but I think he got burned. Of course, Tater Salad and Snake. So, a lot of Snake going on. You know, back then, Dry Lake was all the rage, but now it ain't.
We need to get this back up. We need more dry like DM stuff. So yeah, whoever's listening to this, get on that.
There was, like, last week or a week ago, there was an event at Dry Lake, and people were, like, shooting each other and stuff, and some new cops pulled in, like, on Dry Lake and started arresting people. They really didn't, like, even understand that you're not supposed to arrest, you know, just let people fight because it's Dry Lake event.
Yeah, Dry Lake is sacred ground. Like, you let that, like, that's where the shit goes to end.
Exactly.
Were you there, Rashawn, when that happened?
Last week, no.
I think it was last week, and like me and Steppo were cupping, and we were like driving around, and there were a bunch of warrants at the Dry Lake, and we just went there and we watched, and we didn't arrest anyone, obviously, because we were just like spectating people fight. And then like some new cops pulled in like with their cop car, and they just started arresting everyone, and everyone was like, what the fuck, you know, you don't do that when it's Dry Lake event.
They just don't understand the sacredness of Dry Lake, you know what I mean? Down B. Next screenshot, you got Alexander Yo-Yo-Yo in this fucking screenshot.
He's actually on server right now, I think, no?
That's why I put it in here. I want to give him a shout out.
This was Rayo's party shack. Disco light, sauna, everybody having fun and dancing and shit. Cash if you can in the background, too. Big fucking GG house party before the Friday night parties came in. Let's see, top of Chiliad here. You got Eustace14. Fucking Dot Dude. Dr. Vist, a lot of fucking old dudes around here. Blowing up freeways. Wrong. Yep, the original Christie.
Not
Mug Christie Edge. No, Mug Christie Edge is the budget Christie Row. That's how it is. next one.
American Gangster. It's all
right. American Gangster? Where? Oh, I see him. Yeah.
Mika's in this too. I didn't even notice that.
Yeah. Andre as well.
Andre B.
Andre.
Mika the S? Yeah, I see him there. He's on the PCJ that time though.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see, the next one, y'all following the fucking train, y'all were infatuated with the fucking train.
It was new.
It was
like
new.
You can't be new in CNR. Like, when something new happens, you have to go experience it right away. Because it doesn't happen often.
Yeah, and the flavor runs out pretty quick, so you gotta get it going. Another screenshot on Chiliad, Spawn X. Yeah, I love Edmonds a lot.
Yeah, tried to read anything. It's like everyone.
Yeah, I've got.
It was that many people that were there. Like that's, like how these events went.
Yeah, I've got my face in the screen right now. My fucking face in the screen trying to read these fucking names, but yeah, there are so many.
Captain John.
Oh, the a teddy bear was in the next screenshot though, in the what was that, a tanker. A teddy bear, fucking Kratos, Skyline, Nanu. I mean, this is old fag at its fucking finest right here. Zybarts. A teddy bear long gone. That dude was very chill. You know what I mean?
Yeah, he was a cool admin to have on the server. Like, for the few people that would come on at that time, like, he was one you'd want on.
That's true, the fucking mouse.
How you say his name? 89? Wasn't like the story that he thought that like for people to get kicked or banned or something, I don't know, someone would need to type in your name, not ID, and overcomplicated name so people couldn't like type it in or something, and then you can do it by ID anyone. I heard this story somewhere, I don't know if it's true or not.
I think Jayance might have said it, but I don't know why. I just say Slimmy Jim Jim. That's what I say his name is, Slimmy Jim Jim.
The name is just, it's too complicated.
I don't know how he remembers that. No idea.
That screenshot with Slimmy Jim Jim and mice and all them, that was like for some reason we had like a Michael Jackson death party.
Oh yeah.
And this is what it was.
Wow. What would Valeris say to this?
I think he'd say, yeah. Everybody putting respect on Michael Jackson. Wow! That's what he'd be saying. Yeah, that was 2009 also, right? Yeah, Nears. Yeah, that was the name of the fucking group. Nears. Yeah. Some respect on Michael Jackson. There's Cloud Is Me next screenshot. Given the
just flexing my DMH. Yeah. They have my back. I think they still do.
They still do. Once DMH, always DMH. That's how it is, you know. They look for you, don't look for them. And Cloud Is Me, he was playing like last year, the year before. He had come back. I don't know where he is now, though. Let's see. Christy Rowe, next screenshot, and the fucking Banshee, bouncing. Best car even back then. Before 2010, EG. Let's see, Death the Meek, next screenshot, saying Death is better than DMH, better than Sam, better than new groups. Well, I mean...
Just so we know the rank, like, that still stands today. So everybody knows Death is better than everyone else.
Okay. I'll give you your opinion.
They're still around, right?
I don't think so. But I'll give you your opinion.
Yeah, just one of those gang of the month gangs?
Might have been, yeah. 2 weeks. See you in 2 weeks. That's what it is.
Someone is saying in chat, I want a Core i7-980X Extreme.
Who?
Who? What CPU is that?
Was it 2010? That probably came out during the time of these screenshots. Let's see here. Chainsaw Party here. Then guys in a DFT 30 going around.
I was just flexing that I had a screenshot of Vic. Like, I don't know. He's like one of the really oldest admins there.
Yeah, Vic gone now. Fucking gone.
He's gone. Are you on that cop tank on the next one?
No, I'm definitely not on that cop tank. Cop tanks for me didn't start till like 2012. Definitely was not on this one. Let's see here. A few screenshots down, there are a few people, including you, Robot Monkey, JCW, looking for a ride.
That's an old couple, too.
What, Robot Monkey and JCW?
That was something, I think.
It was? I had no idea.
Back in the day, and then, well, we know where they are now.
What's the police gonna save us?
Well, we know where JCW is. I don't know where Robot Monkey is, though.
You know who won.
Yeah. Depleted Bin Took That. The Amazon woman. Let's see here.
Just another, you know, showing how bad I am, how good I am at dying. I have no idea who that is, but he killed me.
Swizzle Stick with the gloves on, destroying you.
The boxer skin. Yeah. The biggest retards ever wear.
That was really popular when, during the Mayweather, McGregor fight. A lot of people had that shit on.
Yeah, I think there was also one dude who was, I don't know, recently, maybe like last 4 years or maybe like 4 years ago. There was a dude who was always like boxer skin and he was just punching everyone in a prison. All he did all day long was just be in prison, punch people, get released, go to City Hall, punch people, get warrant, go to prison, punch people. Like,
that's all you want to do?
Don't know how you don't get bored of that. But yeah.
Let's see. Next one, we got Miss Zenex Uche. Yeah, and Imnis, bro from another Mo. Had the same skin since back then.
Like what you said, bitches love Met Cow.
It's true, they really do.
They do about that.
I thought this was just a cool shot with Zenex and Mitch and Uche at the same time.
This is a cool shot.
You got DM'd by Vexer.
Vexer on a fucking rampage.
Vexer, was that before he was AFK'er?
Yeah.
Yeah, so anybody who's complaining about DMing now, like, you could straight up go into City Hall and just destroy everyone quickly.
Yeah. No admin on, even if there was an admin on, probably. Just fucking...
He's like, we need proof.
Shoot your shot.
Has Lester seriously not changed skin in his entire
life? No, that's his skin, man. That is his skin.
Oh my god, I thought maybe...
Danang boy.
I thought maybe at least in like old screenshots I'll see Blister in some other skin, but... Yeah.
Blister's Danang boy screenshot. Yeah, Andromeda there before she turned a bit weird. This was back when Blister and Neophyte were buddy-buddy, you know, arms together, you know what I mean? And Moody, there you go. Let him bounce you on that fucking bull. Count, whatever the fuck that is. Let's see, Ham Schiller getting DM'd again. Liberty Mafia, that was a cool dude. But
was he?
I think he was a cool dude. But you got destroyed there. Lil Tank timed out on the same screenshot.
That makes sense.
G fucking G, I'm telling you. Next one. Oh shit, Vega's in the screenshot. Everything's in that screenshot. Fucking
Gossip Slash. This is when items first came into play. That was something new, so people started really going into the item stuff.
Yeah, because back then, like, Street Vendor was just a set list of items, but you can make it customizable, right? After this.
I meant, like, the clothing. Like, before...
Oh, the clothes? Oof.
Yeah. Oof.
Yeah, I don't know. I didn't really like the clothes. The clothes really, it didn't enamor me. But the
I just
parrot,
wanted that bird.
The sideways parrot. Fucking shit. Let's see. Next one in the, at the airport, Fugazi Fanta is in the screenshot. Shout out to that dude. Panda, you had a dildo in your hand right there, of course. Oh shit, next screenshot. This was, you know, Brody and you, Brody and you actually got to know each other after getting that amount of money from the birthday thing. So, bygones, sit together in the fucking sand, you know?
Yeah, actually, I was still salty about that whole situation years later, to the point where, like, Brody got admin, and I was pissed. Because I was like, he's a DMer, still in my mind. I'm fine with, like, I like Brody, like, there's no, that'd be stupid if I was still pissed and salty about it, but I remember back when he got admin, I made, like, a ranting forum post.
Oof.
I don't know where it is, but it's somewhere. I'd be like, why the fuck, blah, 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 he's a DMer. And I was just mad because I didn't get it.
Didn't you say you bring up some posts or something?
Yeah, yeah, we'll get to them. We'll get to that.
Is that one of them?
No, it actually isn't. Probably, I didn't see that. either that or I mean, he had like 50 pages of posts, so I only looked through like 12. And I think I saw like 10 screenshots, so that's how it'd be. Next few screenshots, I think, is a panda. Is that a panda made thing? That pirate ship,
yeah.
Fucking cow. Myth saying he has to go home.
I think the next few just kind of series, like, I could never do this stuff as an admin, like, make all these, like, roads and all that stuff in the sky. Like, I couldn't do it. So whoever makes these, like, just good job.
Ghost Hunter does them these days. I think he's the only one who really is, like, really good at building, like, a lot of tracks and stuff.
Yeah, Ghost Hunter is the dude for that. Gonna skip down here. I think I looked at a screenshot here from the CNR Mumble era. A lot of cocksuckers in the same channel. I think I was...
Well, you have Justo as well. He's back. Justo.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, he was back a few days ago.
Yeah, he tried to get Parrish to come to Finland. Obviously.
Wow, Parrish has a lot of offers now from Finland.
Yeah.
Yeah, this was... I think this was one of the last, like, big events I was a part of. And I was an admin at this point, too.
Oh, so, my God.
It was the CUSA anniversary. I remember this.
Sean, you have Bostakot too.
Who?
Bostakot too.
What about him?
They're in the last before... No, the one before Discord picture. You have Bostakot too and Rob Banks.
So the one with the bananas?
Wow.
Yeah, computer.
The bananas one, that's actually recent. I threw that in here because, like, now try to play, I like remember the old events that would happen. Like, every once in a while I try to do something fun with the players that are around, because I mean it's not fair to not do stuff with these newer players. Like, I still try to do stuff, but it's not the same.
Yeah, it's not. It's
Wow, look at that. That was Mumble, no? Yeah, look at those people. Holy shit.
It was the ass team. I mean the not excuse me the CUSA anniversary. That Discord was quite autistic as well.
And Mish is also in.
Yeah, Mish Mix.
Mish Mix.
He had like the deepest voice.
His voice was so deep.
Yeah, it's
It's funny though, no? I mean, kind of ironic, but.
I don't want to talk shit. There's other funny stuff, but I don't want to talk shit about Mish Mix. I liked him.
I liked him a lot. He was always nice to me. I don't know. And he, like, he never, like, really shit-talked or something. He always, like, kept it, like, simple. And he wasn't, like, shy or something, but he didn't talk, like, a bunch of stupid shit. I felt like he was well-spoken.
Yeah, it's true. He just, you know. He joined in with the Make Fun of Belarus train, you know what I mean? Like, that was actually really funny. There's a video of, you know, talking about, because Belarus is a big Miami Heat fan, and Mish Mix would be like, well, you know, Miami Heat, you know, you look at Chris Bosh, he, you know, because there's a screen or a video of Chris Bosh, he's a player in Miami Heat. When they won the championship, he poured champagne on his head, and his face does not look very good. It looks very, anyway, very gee. But, so he was like, yo, Miami Heat, they've got the Miami Heat butt plugs, you know, that's what they do to each other. And Belarus would get mad, and they would, you know, fuck around with each other, and shit was funny. I think there's still a video around about that. But yeah, Mish Mix was a cool dude. Very cool dude. Let's see here. All right, so, getting the screenshots.
So the screenshots. Yeah, that's the end. Here. I think I put this one last. Just welcome to CNR forever, because it's kind of true.
True. It is quite true. Let's see. I didn't reread these here. I think they're out of. Hold on, I have to set ShareX to upload directly. So I'm gonna put some screenshots in chat, and we're gonna try to see what Hamchilla was thinking. Let's see here. What is this? This is a screenshot of you know, to reinforce how in 2020 people are like, oh, we don't have enough admins. Admins don't have any covering. But Fantastico Nemo was like, admins are lazy as shit. And they disabled my account for no reason. Blah blah blah.
Yeah.
But. See, it's the same as it was back then. Now, it's just
that, how he wrote, you know, like, lazy bastards.
Bastards, yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, this is an old screenshot. This is from the old forum, right?
Yeah, the old forum. 2009,
so I was definitely still... I was kissing ass in 2009. I already had those admin sites on my mind. I'm like, all right, if I kiss enough ass, I'll get there one day.
Well, there you go. You did a good job. That was a good post, you know? 2009, well, 2020, same thing.
I read that paragraph before I saw the date, and I'm like, I could have posted that like a year ago. Like, it's fairly true, even though I didn't have the experience. I still feel the same way.
It's true. It's the exact same snit as it was back then, you know? Just time morphed, you know? Let's see here. Next one, you said there's a topic, McDonald's or KFC? And you would rather have KFC. If you were to get fast food, are you still a KFC dude?
So I moved to a town where there's only a McDonald's in it. Ugh. For like fast food.
Ugh.
Yeah, ugh. But like, ugh. It's open 24/7, so it's kind of like super convenient when I'm up at like 2 o'clock in the morning.
And it's still 24 hours to this day, right? Even during all this crap going on, right?
Yeah, McDonald's doesn't fuck around.
Of course.
They don't give a fuck.
They pay a lot of money.
I'd probably say if I could go to a KFC right now, I'd go to a KFC, but I'd have to choose McDonald's just because that's mostly what I do right now.
Once you dabble on other things, McDonald's is pretty shitty in my opinion.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Let's see here. Next one, another admin type thing. I guess some dude was posting, what's the point of having admins if they probably don't do shit? And here you're saying, make everybody an admin. Then, you know, no problem.
I mean, I was being sarcastic.
Yeah, well, Some of these do happen.
It would solve all the problems, right? Like, why would anybody cheat or hack if they're an admin? They can do everything they want.
Exactly. And if an admin cheats, well, the admins, other admins on the server can ban the fucking admin cheater. So, but that, there you go.
I have to say, if Crazy Bob decided one day to just completely shut it down, I'd wish he'd just give everybody a week of just being admin. I just would love to see what the fuck would happen.
Wow. Chaos and turmoil. That's what it would be. This one, the RPB4 video, you were like, hey, I want to be in the RPB4. That's a long time ago. What, 11 years ago? No, Jeez. 8 years ago. That's...
Did you track down the video?
No, I didn't. I didn't look at the RPB4.
That was a fucking mess in that video. Those videos were never good. Not okay, I shouldn't say that. But like the pictures in the videos were like, it was very such a mixed bunch.
Yeah, it's true. All the low quality pictures in there, I mean, it was pretty good for the time, but I don't know. Everybody was young back then too, so
that's why it's weird to look at back at it now.
Exactly. That's the thing. Let's see here. This one, okay. Oh, yeah. We talked about being a rapist. Well, you tried being a rapist once, and you got $20 million in debt.
But that. Yeah, this is when I talked about San Fierro being like my throwaway life city. Mm-hmm. This is where it started. I tried doing it. I died a bunch of times, and I was like, "Fuck it, I'll just commit."
Oh, and well, can't argue with that shit. You know, a lot of people back then, they had one city that was more of a throwaway city. I think Gangsta Pimp Player. His throwaway city was, well, other than LB, everything else is throwaway city. let's see here. 2009, back when you thought girls had cooties, like that?
Yeah. They still kind of do, don't they?
yeah, they do.
They have the corona.
Sean wouldn't know.
Who?
It's been a long time he had...
Next screenshot. Remember Mostafe?
What was that context of the other one?
I don't know what the context was. I have actually no idea. I've had time to calm down. I guess some guy was really mad, and they made a rage post, and then they, you know, calmed down on a different topic. I have no idea. But
were you actually in the video then? Oh, there's a screenshot where it says, I want to be in the video of regular players. Were you in it?
I definitely was in one, and then I don't think I was in any after that.
Owned. Well, you got your taste, you know what I mean? That's all you need. One RPB.
I have a few pictures in that mega thread, though.
That mega thread is dead because most people posted on TinyPic.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Yeah, true.
TinyPic was the thing back then.
Yes, when you go looking back, like really old players or something, it's all like that link that. Yeah. Rip. You can actually see those who posted on something else on some other hosting. They were like ahead of time, you know. Kinda. You could say now they were ahead of time, but yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, they kind of were. This screenshot here, dude, remember Mostafe? That guy was a fucking head case.
I'm sure he was. There's all the head cases, about they're all blending together in my mind.
Yeah.
This is a classic 2009 stupid trolling sentence, isn't it?
It is. I don't know what the troll is. Well, you know, you answered your own question. Look. Next one here. Let's see here. Oh. Wait a minute. What's it say? Oh, this is how you said how you got the name Hamchilla. That should have been the first question.
Yeah. I think I was on like RuneScape or something beforehand on like my old, I don't even remember my old user accounts were. But I was like just talking shit with some dude and somehow this name popped up and I just got attached to it. And that's been my name ever since.
It's a good compound word, I'll tell you that.
It catches people's attention. And for some reason, like, I feel like it's common, like, people get what it is, like, a combination of, but every once in a while, somebody will just be like, what does that mean?
I guess they have never been around a hamster or a chinchilla, you know? It's,
or they think, I forget what it was, but do you remember Hamachi? It was like a where you could play multiplayer in some games. Some would think it would be that, or like I know a lot of Europeans would just be like H A M C H. I'm like, what is that? Amch?
Amch? Amch, yeah. So the Borats do back in those times. Speaking of that, what is this?
Oh, I found that at my grandfather's house. Actually, I'm in that room right now. What? Like, I'm in the kitchen where that was taken. And I posted that because of Sheepfucker.
Yeah.
Look at the photo bucket, though.
I dug some of the screenshots out of Photo Bucket. I still have access to that account.
Damn, I thought it was dead.
It is. I mean, clearly.
You gotta pay now.
As soon as they logged on, they asked for like $60. I'm like, no.
Oh. I mean, how in the world? Where did this figurine come from? The fuck.
So I'm assuming my grandfather got it as a joke because there's a sheep farmer behind our house. So I don't know.
Just throw it in his yard one day.
Ask Sheepfucker.
Yeah, I gotta bring this up to her one day. Oh boy.
She still comes around?
No, but everybody on CNR has her Facebook. Literally.
Everyone has her on Facebook, though.
Everybody has her on Facebook.
I think she wished me a happy birthday this year, too. And I don't even go on Facebook.
She accepts every Facebook. Like, back in the day, like, she knew she had everybody's Facebook. 2009, back when Stickam was a thing, huh?
Yeah. That was every once in a while at CNR Stickam group would get together. It was weird. Alright, I don't know if Myth will get pissed at me, but I have some weird screenshots of Myth with a banana.
That makes sense.
Sounds interesting.
It makes sense.
So I blackmail him every once in a while with it.
Gotta give me 100 euros, bitch. Let's see. This is JNB. Another 2009 feeling. Why are admins online if they do nothing? That has aged on throughout the years.
Wow.
Do we still want to play? Maybe.
That's true.
Has changed. Everything in CNR comes full circle, man.
It really hasn't changed. Like, I understand why people get annoyed, and, like, I was annoyed in the past, too, but once you kind of get over that hump of, like, it's always going to be this way in some form, you just go, okay, whatever, I'm just going to play.
That's true. Just play the damn game, cocksucker. Next one, a bit later, after the old forums phased out, you're still here, 2014, and you're still there. What year is it? It's 2014.
Just flexing, you know.
Yeah, flexing.
There is one thread active in the old forums that every once in a while somebody bumps, and it's just kind of like just flexing how old you are.
I can't blame you for that. Plus, your avatar is still intact. I'm going to get to that in a bit. And this one's the last one I have here. Hamoria.
I'm still in the talks of trying to get that in the game.
Naming yourself after disease, huh? Replace gonorrhea with hamoria. Don't need AIDS. Fuck AIDS.
Yeah, I think somebody either suggested that AIDS got added to the game or something, and then I was just like, nah, hamoria. I need it.
Yeah, I'd rather hamoria, because AIDS doesn't go away. You know?
Could you imagine if you had a disease in the game where, like, it would just slowly kill you, it would never go away, you'd die, and then the next time you respawn, it's still going to slowly kill you. You'd be shit.
That would be very annoying, so we can't have AIDS on CNR. But so one last thing about the old forums before we go to the player questions on the forum. Most of the people on the old forum, because Pro Boards has devolved into some kind of crap, the default avatar is very unsettling.
What is it?
I meant to get a screenshot of it to put it in here. I think I'll get it in a bit. But first, last part of the show, let's get to the forearm. All these cocksuckers in LB, all right? Listen, give me 10 minutes, all right? We'll get through these in 10 minutes to end the show, okay? I'm getting bombarded by cocksuckers who somehow get banned every week by not any fault of their own, probably. Or probably follow their own. We'll get to the unmans in a bit, cocksucker. Okay. But I'm going to find that picture. But first question is from Yanagiv, who is also another... Yanagiv, who's another Slovenian dude. He asked, what's your favorite animal? I'll tell you these questions, man.
I think I like penguins probably the most, or maybe just like dogs. Like, I'm a dog person. I wish I had a dog. I don't have one, so probably dogs.
I get those dogs.
Do you ever have hamster or...
Chinchilla. I had a chinchilla. I had a chinchilla in like 2009.
What happened?
So like I lived the gimmick.
Did you flush it down the toilet like Rashawn did with his goldfish?
I thought you were about to say like hamster or some shit, and I was like, what the fuck, Rashawn?
Nah. But the goldfish was already dead.
Oh, poor goldfish.
Well, where did I put it? I think I did flush it down the toilet. Yeah. You can't put me in charge of pets. Like that. That's not gonna work. You answered the question. But here's the default avatar for the Pro Boars thing.
Is that what the fuck is that? It's like somebody tried to draw a person, but I was like, I don't really remember what they look like.
I don't know, but that form is full of it. It's full of
if that thing comes into my fucking house tonight and like I wake up in the middle of the night, it's like standing over me, I'm gonna be pissed.
Someone's dying of shock, bro. I die of shock. Let's hear, let's go to Lipex. In fact, Lipex has the only other questions here. And then we'll finish up. He asked, first question, tea or coffee?
I don't really drink caffeine, but I like iced tea. I'm sure some people get shitty at me from that.
Oh, God.
And I like the taste of coffee, but probably tea.
Yeah, I'd agree. Like, last week we had Lipex on the show. Holy shit, I was in fucking UK fucking hell. I'm talking about tea the entire fucking show.
For me.
Next question. Given the choice of anyone in the world, dead or alive, who would you want as a dinner guest?
Probably Dave Chappelle. I'm a big stand-up fan. And he just seemed like the coolest person to just sit down and just shoot the shit with.
Dave Chappelle's a fucking boss. Everybody gets mad. I think a lot of people got mad at his last, set. But see, the problem is, these people out here, they cannot read between the lines. They take what they see literally, and they don't got the brain capacity. I mean, they're basically a typical senior player. You know what I mean? So, Dave Chappelle's a fucking boss. That's what it is. Next one from Lipex. He asked, what type of music are you into?
My favorite band is MGMT. So kind of around that area, or like Tame Impala, Pond. That's usually where I stick around these days.
What sort of music is that? I don't know. What genre is that?
I guess neo-psychedelic on that kind of area.
That confused me more.
Yeah. It's like I usually don't talk music with people because I'm very like specific and kind of an outlier on stuff.
You should make some mix. I don't know for CNR Radio.
I think I'm not allowed to do CNR Radio. I did it once and Sphincter Bonaire got pissed at me.
Why?
Well, because the first issue was I downloaded like the wrong thing and there was like dead air time. This was like the first week it got live. So there was dead air time trying to get me to fix it.
Owned.
And then I was such an asshole that I played like the 20-minute long version of Shine On You Crazy Diamond by Pink Floyd. No.
20 minutes. Oh, wow. No. Where's the variety, cocksucker? Oh.
So the other day, Doogie posted his upload speed and download. I think he has like something like 300 or 400 download and 100 upload or something, like some insane speed. And I still remember, like, I talked with him like 2 months ago or something. I was asking him like to upload new mixes on the radio, you know, because there's a bunch of old mixes, and he said no because it takes too long or too much time. And I'm thinking, like, the dude has insane upload speeds. Like, he could probably upload everything like in 2 seconds, you know.
Dougie's a busy man.
Listen.
But don't know if it's called busy or apathic or whatever is the word.
I don't know. He
don't give a shit.
He's a good person right now. I respect whatever he's trying to do right now.
Well, he'll have to be more transparent about that shit, because I don't get it either. I've been trying to get radio admin in this shit for like 2 years, and ain't nothing. But yeah, GG. I guess this next one from Lipex is kind of hand-in-hand, but he asked favorite musician, so I guess a person specifically, I guess.
Yeah, it would be the same. Well, I mean, MGMT is the favorite band. I don't know about, like, a solo musician. I guess probably, maybe, like, Kid Cudi I enjoyed a lot. Kid Cudi. But I don't really listen to him that much anymore.
Yeah, me neither. I think I listened to his rock album. After that, I was like, yeah, I don't think so. Next one. Second to last question. He asked, favorite film of all time?
Probably Kill Bill. I'm planning on watching that soon because I haven't watched in a while, but I always enjoy watching that movie.
Well, we're in the quarantine era. Kill Bill can be the next thing on. Is that me?
How do you spend days in quarantine, actually? What do you do?
I am currently going crazy. I've been watching The Office. I've never watched The Office before, so I'm going through The Office.
Every woman likes The Office, and I don't get it.
It's because of the Pam and Jim thing. They just, I'd love to find... Yeah, okay. I'm getting kind of sick of it, but I don't give up on shows.
Oh, man, I never watched The Office at all.
Can you work from home or something like that? I mean...
Yeah, I work from home about an hour a week, and that's about it.
I wonder.
Why is that?
I'm a high school teacher.
You're for real? Okay. Just 1 week? Just 1 hour per week if you're a teacher? Don't they get like assignments and stuff from you?
Yeah, I give them assignments, but like the classes themselves, like we have like 30-minute online meetings. I have them on Mondays, and then I give them work for the rest of the week. But we were told by like the administration that you just need to hold like one per class per week. So that's what we do. And I give them work to do, but I don't have to actually go and do stuff right now.
Yeah. What if it's not really a secret? What are you teaching?
I teach computer science and software engineering.
GG. Nice. Like just everything and a bit of everything, or like specifically something like Java or I don't know.
In Java. So I went to school for computer science and software engineering, and then I just kind of transitioned into this teaching gig because like the pay is not as great as if I was like an actual software engineer, but I only have to work 150 days out of the year.
Can I agree with that? Can I agree with that? What the?
See, I was just doing assignment for someone last 2 days in Java. Because they were too lazy to do it for their own uni, so I did it for them.
Is it one of my students?
No.
You never know.
I don't think so.
You never know.
Yeah, but otherwise you would give him a fail? Or would you tell them to just
Here's the thing, is I've caught students cheating, like they'll turn in assignments that either they gave to another person or found it online, and it's like, if I found this, that's the problem. It's not even about that you cheated, it was like, I found this.
Yeah.
Can't trick Hamchilla.
Being an admin really got me prepared to watch over high school students.
Well, I mean, that was kind of what you were doing as an admin, so yeah, that's very true. It's very true. And final question here of the interview, or at least of the player submitted questions from Lipex. This has been a meme for the past month. He asked, would you rather fight 100 chinchilla-sized horses or one horse-sized chinchilla?
Okay. I have so many problems with these kind of questions. and here's my rebuttal to that. I'm going to ask you a question, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Would you rather fight a horse or 100 chinchillas? Because it's not the animal mix that matters. It's the size.
That's true. Obviously, chinchillas are very small. Oh, wait. Okay. The baseline question is, would I rather fight a chinchilla or a horse? without anything else.
Pretty much. Yeah, like, oh, would you rather, like, it's still a horse-sized something. Like, that's a big fucking thing.
I'd rather fight the chinchilla. You know? Okay, so you're saying if there are 100 of those horses, but they're still small, then, you know, that'd be easy, right?
Yeah, just, like, go on and take... Jump up and down, you're good.
Yeah, exactly. But
a horse, or a horse-sized chinchilla, you'd be fucked. No matter what.
Yeah, you'd get clawed. You're absolutely clawed, so...
The other day, I watched on... I don't know where I was, actually, on Twitter or on YouTube or on Twitch. I don't remember. There were people asking girls, like Twitch streamers, what is heavier, like 1,000 pounds of feather or 1,000 pounds of steel?
Well, obviously it's steel.
And like, seriously, like 90% people fail on that. And I'm like, how? I understand, like, you're 12 years old or 13 and you don't think through questions.
Hold on, why are you watching 13-year-old Twitch streamers?
Oh,
I mean, no, they weren't 13. They were just Twitch streamers, girls, you know? But it just proves point that most of those girls streaming are dumb as shit, man. Like, I understand you're 13 years old.
I'll stick up for them. I'll stick up.
How you feel that, like, as an adult person? Huh?
Because the question is designed to trick somebody into making them look stupid. It's not, because if you have steel and you have feather, of course, if you felt those two, you'd be like, oh yeah, the steel is going to be heavier no matter what. But they're not focusing on the pounds, they're just focusing on the object.
Exactly. But yeah, whatever. It's just, I don't know, I got reminded, I just crossed my mind now that you were talking about what's bigger and heavier and about chinchilla and horses and stuff.
Yeah. I mean, yes, yeah, designed to fuck with you. And once you give them the gotcha, hey, dumbass, it's 1,000 pounds versus 1,000 pounds. They're like, oh shit, I'm a dumbass. You know, that's how it be.
That's you can talk shit about them even if after you explain it to them, they don't understand. That's when you can start talking.
Yeah, that's when it's a problem. I think there's something like that.
Have you ever had a student, by the way, since you're teaching computer science, that you were just like, yeah, this person ain't gonna, like, they just don't understand, like, programming, or, like, they, no matter how many times you explain, they just don't get it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely.
So what do you do with people like that? I mean, how do you make them, like, have qualification anyway, or do you let them pass, or, I don't know.
It depends. I have two different classes. One is more strict than the other. So in the strict class, I'm like, you're on your own. Like, I'll help you as much as I can, but you still need to put in the work and the effort. With them, it's kind of a sink or swim moment. But I also have an intro class. Sorry, what?
Why is the course called? Like, is it actually called, like, is this like high school or university?
It's a high school. So teenagers, mostly from like 15 to like 18, I teach.
Yeah. Is this like, you can pick this subject or everyone has it? I don't know how American system works.
They pick me in my class. So even with the ones that I have in my class, I'm like, if you're planning, like, with the kind of stricter class, I'm like, you're planning to go to college for computer science if you're in this class. Because if you're not, then you're wasting your time.
Do you get a lot of girls?
Have one this year. I have one in that class.
Maybe.
Is it?
Is she like a nerdy girl, or I don't know, is she doing well?
No, but I don't think I can talk about that.
Absolutely not.
But I have had girls in the past. Like, I have another girl in another class. She's great. I've had a few other girls that, like, have been good. Like, so it's not, this is just like one that's not doing too good.
Yeah. Oh, well, hopefully she won't be too discouraged. I mean, I don't know. It's just like, also, like, some things can be fun and, like, intuitive to you and some not. Like, for example, like, I don't know, some people are really good at algorithms, some people are not, some people would rather make games, some people would rather make, like, web development or something, and you don't necessarily need to be super good in maths and algorithms if you do web developing and stuff. I don't know. Like, people get discouraged pretty quickly, like, but there's just, computer science is really wide. I don't know, it's a lot of things you can try and do.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean. Like, this, the one class, it's very strict, the structure of it, the way I have to teach it, which is unfortunate, but, like, it doesn't really teach development or kind of how to do computer science, like, as I'd like it to be. It's very, you need to learn specific things for Java because they have, like, a standardized test at the end.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, I was eating.
Rashawn totally not interested.
Don't you know how important I am?
Listen, okay. Yeah, obviously, since you're on the show, of course. But, yeah, you see, what I was going to say was, girls for coding, yeah. Get in there, you know what I mean? You got to expand the horizon, so, you know, the more women in the field, better, and, you know, you'll stick out more, obviously. That's going to do it. I think, how long have we been here? Almost 3 hours. I didn't think this would last, like, 40% that long, but,
Really?
But
that... You don't think I would... Exactly. You didn't think I could handle a conversation?
Listen.
We have guest here, finally, an old fag of your era, Rashawn, and now you're just shit-talking.
I'm not shit-talking anybody. Absolutely not. This was a great interview.
You know, I was looking forward to this. I was like, you know what? Me and you haven't really connected much throughout the years. Like, this would be a good place to, you know, start a good friendship. But now you're just pissing all over it. I'm like, you know what? Never mind.
Listen, I'm not pissing over snits, okay? But yeah, this was a great interview. Ham Chilla, you're right. We hadn't conversed that much throughout the years, even though we've seen each other, but this was an excellent opportunity to remind us of that. Go ahead.
I always ask this, I don't know why, but yeah, I will ask you too. It's a meme, but who would you like us interview next? Who would you like to hear? Please encourage some old fags to come on show, because as you see, it's not that... Was it like what you expected? Was it worse? Was it better? Was it... I don't know. What was your take on this interview coming in?
I had a good time. I honestly know I was just talking shit, but like, yeah, I didn't think it would last as long either, but it flew by. I had a good time. I think everything flowed pretty naturally too.
It did.
Do you have anyone that you would like to hear them on the radio? I don't know.
You want me to make Myth come on here?
Was he? I think he was already here.
I think we had Myth already.
I don't think Kesh was here.
You want me to
here,
call Mika the ass real quick? See if his number still works?
Yeah. Get Mika the ass up. You know what I mean? That'll bring Metal Face out of the the bushes. You know what I mean?
Why didn't we have Metal Face, Rashawn? You could sort that one.
Yeah. I guess I could.
You're slacking on your part, man.
That's the idea.
Trying to think of who... Who's still around? Who, like, who haven't you got? Who do I still talk to?
BMUK. I don't know. I just have no idea. There's a huge pool of people, you know, so I have no idea, really.
We didn't have Cats, did we? Cats would talk to me. Cats
Swallow? You never know. You never know.
I mean, he's in Discord channel lot, so I don't know. Is he talking there? I'm not actually there in that.
There are times where he just go in there, chilling, you know. So, yeah.
What about a music box?
Shy.
I never heard his voice before. I know. Who knows? We could if I put some effort into it. Yeah.
Maybe Acer. I like Acer.
Have you heard him before?
I've never heard him. I think he's Spanish, from Spain.
Yeah, someone's saying he's Romanian, so I have no idea. So, I know, it's weird. A lot of weird people in CNR, you know? That's how it always is, but,
I wanted to have Ghost Hunter, but he's shy, too. Everyone's so shy, man.
Oh, see? The thing is that everybody except from America and the UK is fucking shy. So,
can we track down Panda somehow? I don't know how the fuck we could do it, but I would love to have an interview with Panda.
I don't know. Panda seems long gone. Dead is dead. I don't know. And even we could...
How old would she be now?
I don't think anybody knew anything about Panda.
Yeah.
Weird, isn't it? Sometimes, like, you can be hanging around with people all the time and stuff, but then in the end you have no contact left. You actually know very little of them and stuff like that.
I'm pretty sure Panda is around me and Hemchilla's age now. Yeah. Yeah, who knows? Who knows? There's a lot of crap in the horizon. Maybe I have Panda on Steam, but I haven't talked to Panda in like 4 years. Find longer. So, I've got to go through the cobwebs to try to find that. But, excellent interview, Hemchilla. It was Bounce. People get reminded that you're still an admin. Well, that's...
Oh, you will get ton of PMs.
Trust me, I'm not even good enough to cheat.
And no cheating from you. But yeah, that'll do it. Dead is dead. We're done here. Almost 3 hour interview. Fucking Bounce. For Kesh and Hemchilla. We'll see you next time on the CNR Radio interview session. Enjoy LB, the worst city in the world.